shots at Jacob Markstrom, who was absolutely perfect. Coming off a tough loss to the Winnipeg Jets on Saturday, the Flames are looking to bounce back against Sidney Crosby and the Penguins. TELUS Flames Hockey is next on Sportsnet.
TELUS Flames Hockey on Sportsnet. Brought to you by TELUS, the network that gives back to help connect Canadians in need. Let's make the future friendly.
In southern Alberta, late in November, and the Calgary Flames getting set to welcome the Pittsburgh Penguins, rather, as we welcome you inside the Scotiabank Saddle Dome. Ryan Leslie along with you. Welcome back, and this is a special one. Been a couple years since the Penguins have been in town, and, you know, this is the third and final home game of this mini homestand for the Calgary Flames before they head out on the West Coast for four games against division rivals. They've got some work to do. You know, they had won four in a row. They had points in five, and then all of a sudden things kind of changed against Winnipeg on Saturday night, and it was a game where they would have a lot of shot generation. They have 36 shots against the Jets. There are parts of their game that they are happy with. They liked a lot of what they did, but they came up the short side. It was a 4-2 loss, as everybody will recall, but they're looking to kind of get that momentum back, and what better test than against Sidney Crosby and the Penguins before, again, as we mentioned, they head out onto the road. So lots to learn and lots to take away from that game, but a similar situation with the Penguins, who, you know, they had won five in a row, and they were rolling. In fact, they go into Montreal on Saturday. They put up 50 shots against the Canadiens and Jake Allen, who was absolutely sensational. It was a 6-3 loss, however, that night. Jake Allen stealing the show, and the Penguins are looking to start a new streak. Now, the last time these two teams met, you'd have to go back to October 28th, earlier this season. They didn't have Sidney Crosby. They didn't have Jeff Carter or Chris Letang or Evgeny Malkin. Well, they've got Letang. They've got Sidney Crosby, and they certainly have the likes of Carter as well. But Malkin is not going to be in this game, but he is with the team, so that's encouraging. So a different-looking lineup for the Penguins tonight, and both teams looking to get back on track. Rick and Kelly will have the call tonight, but first we'll get you set with the national anthems here at the Scotiabank Saddle.
Good evening and welcome to the Scotiabank Saddle Dome for tonight's game between the Pittsburgh Penguins and your Calgary Flames. We ask you to please rise, remove your hats, and join the singing voice of the Calgary Flames, Jord Kanyon, accompanied by Flames organist Willie Jewson and members of the Calgary Police Service in the singing of tonight's national anthems.
So proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. All the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. The true North, strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land. Glory.
Final game, 3-game homestand for the Calgary Flames. First game, 5-game road trip for Sidney Crosby and the Pittsburgh Penguins. Welcome to TELUS Flames Hockey. Rick Ball, Kelly Rudy in the broadcast booth. And Jacob Markstrom back between the pipes for the Calgary Flames. He still leads the league with in shutouts this season with 5, and that included a 45-save performance and a terrific outing in their first meeting with the Penguins 1 month ago in Pittsburgh. At the other end, Tristan Jarry, he has been rock solid for the Pens. 5-game winning streak for him, including 3 shutouts and only 2 goals against in that stretch. He's 3-0-1 in his career against Calgary.
And Rick, I think I speak for a lot of hockey fans. It's going to be a great night with Sidney Crosby back in the lineup for the Penguins. It's only going to be his 10th game, but he is heating up. His last 2 games is a goal and 3 assists. So a special moment to have Sidney Crosby here in the Scotiabank Saddledome.
Off-season wrist surgery, came back for 1 game, then got COVID. Right. Missed another handful of games, but he's in the lineup now and starting to go. And the Flames will send out Michael Backlund in that line with Coleman and Mangiapane to match up against the Crosby line with Rodriguez and Gensel. Hanifin and Anderson on the blue line for Calgary to start. Letang and Dumoulin for Pittsburgh. We're set to go, and we are underway at Scotiabank Saddledome. Glad to have you with us on TELUS Flames Hockey. Puck played in right off the draw. 5 seconds in, we get an icing call on the Flames.
All right, if you want to call it superstition or what, or just a routine, but here's Tristan Jarry. Just before puck drop, he's got a little routine that he goes through, and, you know, I like it. Whatever gets you going, right?
Working on a slow pitch form there.
There you go, right? By the way, he has just been outstanding.
He's really good.
There's Hanson playing it ahead, cut off by Dumoulin. He'll feed a pass to Crosby. Backhands it into the corner. Picked up down low by Gensel. To the point to Letang. In deep, Rodriguez. Behind the net, plays it back to the other side. Gensel over to it. Crosby watched by Anderson. Pushes Crosby to the boards. Rodriguez tries to get the puck loose. Crosby still in the battle. Now Rodriguez able to fish it free, trying to put it in front. Crosby had it tipped away by Hanifin. Played back to Letang. Feeds it across, but it comes outside the line, and Dumoulin has to reset, and gives it away to Mangiapane. Wheeling in with Coleman. Shot stopped by Jarry. Rebound. Mangiapane on it. Works the puck towards the point. Plays it down low. Tipped in front. Swatted away by Jarry. Played ahead and steered out by Gensel. And that may be icing on Pittsburgh, and it is, as Chris Tanev gets back.
Okay, first shift, and we've got some great footage of Sidney Crosby and Rodriguez and how they're going to work together. This is what Crosby said. Rodriguez does really well. He can really support the puck. So Crosby's in a battle with Rasmus Anderson. What does Rodriguez do? He separates himself by about 4 or 5 feet. Gets in good position. By the way, Gensel's on that line as well, and he plays a similar style, although he is highly offensive.
Tanev to Shillington to Tkachuk with a shot, and that was blocked. It goes off Sidney Crosby, who plays it all the way around. Tip to the line, out of Tkachuk, keeps it in with a bit of room, makes a move, gets in front, pass blocked, and it's knocked away. Diving was Letang to block that pass in front. Back on it. Lino played it down low. Now it's cleared to the line and out as Tanev has to reset at center ice. So a good chance early for Calgary. Tkachuk back on the attack. He'll whip it around the boards for Tanev. Kluber checks in. Puck comes free to McGinn, and he'll carry out down the wing. Shillington cuts him off and will chase the puck deep into his own end. Leaves it in the corner for Tanev under pressure. Lindholm there too. Kluber in the battle. Puck and feet along the boards. Tip free. Shillington on it. And Johnny Gaudreau makes a play to Pitlick. Gaudreau and company head off. Pitlick heads into the forecheck. Throws a pretty good hit on Pettersson, who puts the puck to the corner. Marino can't get it out. Shot towards the goal by Zadorov. Was tipped, but it went off the leg. Never got through to Jarry. And it's steered back out to the neutral zone. Eric DeBranson fires the puck in. Marino under pressure. Comes in front. Dubé stopped by Jarry on a bit of a changeup. He got that left leg out, made the save, and he's able to cover up.
Some good defensive plays by Pittsburgh. First play, Crosby with a great shot block. And then you're going to see an unbelievable play by Chris Letang. There's a pass by Tkachuk to Lindholm, and I think Jarry got just a bit of it, but it's a spectacular play by Letang. Diving play to take away that cross-crease pass. And then one excellent save, left pad save, threw a little bit of traffic by Jarry on the Dubé shot.
That would have been a tap-in for Tkachuk had that pass got through. Letang with a perfect play, laid the stick down. Mangiapane flips it in. Matheson back to it. Makes a play to Ruedel. Feeds it across. Steered up by Zucker. Backlund has control. Makes a play to Gudbranson. Ahead to Mangiapane. Denied entry by Mike Matheson. Ruedel with the board. Stolen by Kulman. His pass tipped. And settled down by Kapanen, who drops it deeper into his own end as we approach the 3-minute mark of the first period. Long pass to Kasperi Kapanen. He's checked by Shillington. Now Tanev makes a play to Lucic. Steered up by Lewis. Took a pretty good pump by Lafferty, who came in the forecheck. Puck fired back in. Tanev up the boards. Lucic lets it go to Richardson, and away he goes. Plays the puck in this all-former LA King line on the ice for Calgary. And that's whipped down the ice by Pittsburgh, and faceoff will come back to their zone.
Okay, if you're just inserted into the lineup, you've got to make yourself known, and that's what Sam Lafferty does here on the hit on Lewis. Now, Lafferty is replacing Brian Boyle in this lineup, and that is exactly what the coaching staff is looking for.
That's the only change for Pittsburgh lineup-wise, other than Jarry and goal for DeSmith from Saturday's loss to Montreal. Face-off win by Calgary. Hannifin looks for a lane, dumps the puck in behind. Chipped out front by Johnny Gaudreau, knocked away from Tkachuk, and worked through center ice by Dominique Simon, who carries in with Lafferty. Simon cuts to the middle, can't pull the trigger, knocked off the stick by Anderson. Latang lost the puck. Here's a chance for an on-man rush. Gaudreau ahead to Tkachuk. It's a 3-on-1. Tkachuk plays the puck to Lindholm. Stop! Rebound off the lane wide. Great chance there on the 3-on-1. Jarry, a nice save. Second shot, missed the net. That close. Shot by Simone off the leg, well wide. Tkachuk gets the puck in the corner and feeds it up. Dubé can't take the pass. Bumped across. Marino will carry down the right side. Forced to the boards by Dubé, and as a result, they go in offside.
Okay, let's take a look at this play, Rick. I don't recommend this for young goaltenders. Watch this play where Jari's going to put the puck. Just put it right back out in front. Maybe not the safest. Put it in the corner. Here's Letang. So he had his chance to get his glove on that. Around the puck, all of a sudden it's right in the front, and there's Lindholm with two excellent chances. Jarry with the first save, and then you're going to see Lindholm gets the rebound and puts it right through the crease.
Shots 3-0 Calgary.
So it is a weird game, eh? Rick Letang makes a fantastic play to take away that pass from Lindholm. Chuck, and then he bobbles it at their own, or the other blue line. All of a sudden it's a 3-on-1.
It's a game of mistakes, right? He's a terrific player, obviously. The all-time leader in basically every offensive category amongst Pittsburgh defensemen.
Amazing player.
Puck played out. Worked in by Rodriguez. Pressured by Zadorov, who stumbles. Back to his feet with the puck on a stick. Dubé's there, and he'll lift it out. Settled down at center ice by Matheson. Carter bumps it back into his own zone to Chad Ruedel. We approach the 5-minute mark here in the first period. There's Matheson right up the middle. That's off the mark, and that's an icing call. Oh, they're right off. Oh, they did for a second, and then they blow it down anyway.
Providing competitive odds on all sports, Sports Interaction is Canada's odds maker.
This morning, Mike Sullivan was talking about the details of the game. It's all in the neutral zone. It's how you play in the neutral zone. It's whether you're going to be in the offensive zone or you're defending in your own zone.
Of course, he's had a terrific run as head coach of Pittsburgh. Played for Calgary for four seasons as a player back in the days where he wore the pads.
Yeah, I remember him well.
Back to that staff, the 1 year that John Tortorella was in Vancouver, Mike Sullivan was associate coach. Glenn Gullitson was the other assistant. There's another icing call. They all wind up coaching in as head coaches.
Right.
And Sullivan goes to Pittsburgh and wins a couple of Stanley Cups.
And by the way, he's the winningest coach in Penguins history. He beat Dan Bylsma. Bylsma had 252 wins October 20th. Mike Sullivan picked up his 253rd. Win. Now he has 261 on his resume here in Pittsburgh.
Richardson against Carter on the faceoff. Lucic kicks it free, but it goes right to Kapanen to chip it in. Zadorov slows him down and gets back to the loose puck in his own zone with a play to Richardson. Forced to the boards by Carter. Able to get it out. Tipped away from Lewis. Near him by Zucker. Carter caught offside and the whistle blows with 5.5 gone in the first.
And what an interesting year Jeff Carter has had. He has 5 goals. and he just continues to score, right? Maybe not at the pace that we remember when he was in Los Angeles, but he is still such a valuable player. Now, the argument is, with Crosby and Malkin, sure Hall of Famers, would Jeff Carter be in that same group? That's up for debate.
1113th game for him tonight. Kachuk into the zone. Knocked away. Anderson racing over to it. They'll throw it in front. Oh, stop Jarry off control on the redirection. Boy, the Flames have had some chances. Jarry's been good. And Anderson's back on it. Here's Gaudreau back on the attack. Makes a move. Puck knocked away. Another chance. Another save. Jarry. One stop off Lindholm as he steered that line off the tip of the mitt.
He's only, he's only faced five shots, right, Rick, and four spectacular saves.
Talked about his run. He's won five straight, only given up two goals in the process, three shutouts, and you can see why the way he's playing already in this one. There's a chance now with a shot that's blocked. Second chance goes wide as Brock McGinn let it go. Late indeed. And now Kachuk back on the puck. He'll fire a long time, but it's knocked down. Here's a chance, Rodriguez. Shot it wide. Kachuk, check, up front. And a chance by Gensel is blocked. Bounces back to Marino. Rodriguez takes a look. Passes to Gensel. Back to the point now. Marino feeds it across. Henderson retreats. Rister blocked in front. Puck bounces free. Cleared up by Lindholm. And that may be a little too much as it goes all the way down for an icing call.
Chances by both sides. Let's take a look at this Rasmus Anderson pass to Johnny Gaudreau. Right on the take. Perfect. And a great read by Jarry. And then Lindholm gets a chance just seconds later, and Jarry's just gonna get his catching hand on that just barely, just enough. Then Rodriguez is gonna get a nice chance. Excuse me, that was McGinn, and then right after that, Rodriguez had a chance. So plenty of action both ends.
Lindholm wins the draw for the icing call. Puck knocked down the line by Kachuk ahead to Coleman. Now the Flames will finish off the change in that back of the line. The rest of it comes on to face the Crosby unit. Coleman on the forecheck. Marino with a long pass to Gensel. Tipped in for Crosby. Shakes the check at Shillington. It goes down. Played across. Broken up neatly by Mangiapane. He'll carry out. And Mangiapane to Backlund. And he reached back for it. Put himself offside in the process with 12:48 to go. Still waiting for our first goal, but the teams have had some chances. We're goalless on Sportsnet.
Minutes. He's only faced five shots, but he has been extremely busy making a number of key saves for the Pittsburgh Penguins. At this point, Rick, you'd think that it could be most likely 2-0. Another great start by the Calgary Flames, but Jarry's been the reason why it's still tieless or scoreless after 7 minutes. Look at his numbers, last five starts, perfect. Every goalie would love numbers like that, including making 141 saves out of the last 143 shots that he's faced.
Native of Surrey, BC, won a Memorial Cup with Edmonton back in 2014.
Sure did.
And he has been rock solid here. Now Coleman gets the puck across, bounces outside the zone. Tanev lifts it in. Well, they all have the Flames' strength in the first period. They're showing it again in this one. They've scored the first goal 17 of 21 games this season. That is remarkable.
It is.
And it's the biggest reason they've played with the lead more than any other team this year. That'll be an icing call on Calgary as Letang goes back with 12:20 to go in the opening period.
And it was Kurt Muller's turn to speak to the media this morning. He talked about the Flames. And he talked a little bit about the Penguins. I thought it was interesting what he said about Pittsburgh for their defense, because they're so mobile and move the puck so well. You have to get in on the forecheck and make sure that you force the Penguins defensemen to stop so they can't keep skating. Interesting.
Backlund facing off against Rodriguez. Backlund wins the draw with help from Shillington. Now Tanev up the board for Mangiapane, but Ruedel keeps the play onside. Flipped in behind the Calgary net. Shillington will try this side up over the line. Gensel cut it off, bumped it back off the mark. That'll go all the way down. Calgary starts to change as Mike Matheson goes back to it and brings the puck to his own line. Big pass for Gensel just off the mark, and that'll get a few of these icing calls in this first period. Faceoff goes to the other end.
All right, we talked about Crosby. This is only his 10th game, and it was interesting to read some of his comments. You know, he had one practice. He came back from the wrist injury. He went through the COVID protocol, and in the 8 games, he's only had 2 practices. So that's not very good, and that's why He believes he struggles a little bit, although struggling for him is at everybody else's level, a different level, right?
Yeah.
Right? We should all be so. We should all struggle like that.
But yeah, he had that surgery in the summer, an injury that had bothered him for years, he said. Finally got it taken care of. And that's another icing call, although Rodriguez is going to complain that he was there first. So we'll head all the way back down the ice again.
And Sidney Crosby just sees the game at a different level. Watch this play along the boards. He's going to make a blind backhand pass to Rue Riedel. And then they exit the zone. Watch this. Flying pass right onto the tape of Rue Riedel. Now, unfortunately, Rue Riedel didn't make a good play. Yikes a puck, but still an incredible play by Crosby.
All right, they left Pittsburgh change. So it might have been an offside call and rule potential.
Oh, you're right.
That makes more sense because it looked like Rodriguez was there first. Puck to the line, good plays it off to keep it onside. As he finds Dubé in the corner, cut off by Marino, cleaned up by Teddy Bluger, and flipped up by Pettersson. Here's Zadorov. Dubé. On the wing now to Monahan. Pass the flex back and out. Zadorov, center, waits. And fires it in and around. Calgary making changes. Puck comes through the neutral zone. It's fed in by McGinn. Monstrom plays the puck to Tanev in the corner. He'll feed it ahead for Lucic. Checked by Letang. Zucker drops it off. Here's Heinen trying to get through. Stick tied up. Made a pass across the top of the crease. Lewis gets the loose puck on the far side and chips it out. Chris Letang goes back to it. He'll put it up the middle. Up the center ice to Heinen. Chips the puck off the boards. Tanev in the corner. Back up the near side. Bounces free. Stolen momentarily by Simone, but knocked off his stick and back out the center ice. Dominic Simone. Lafferty shoots the stuff by Markstrom. Steers the rebound over Tkachuk. He'll bring it up with a pass to Lindholm. He's had a couple of great chances already. Lindholm in. Puts it around the boards. Puck comes back towards the point. Lafferty intercepts and Simone takes it at center and dumps one in on goal. Midway through the opening period, 5-2 edge and shots Calgary. Still waiting for our first goal in this one as Rasmus Anderson gains center ice, puts it in. Lindholm banks the puck to himself and then gives it to Johnny Gaudreau. Back to Lindholm with a shot, and that's stopped by Jari. And this time he hangs on for a faceoff with 9:55 left in a goalless first period on Sportsnet.
Everyone talking and saw Milan Lucic ejected from the game for that hit on Dylan DeMello. There was some talk about whether or not it was dirty, whether or not it could have been avoided, and maybe who was at blame. But this morning, Lucic had this to say about the incident.
There's responsibility on the hitters to make safe hits. And I'll tell you why. There's guys that have said thank you to me because I've seen them in vulnerable positions and I haven't finished them.
Now let's take a look. This is just minutes ago. There's Lucic going on again, and that's certainly a different looking hit.
Yep. That might have warranted a thank you from McGinn.
A thank you?
Well, he said, right, he's exactly. That guy say thank you to him, right?
I guess.
Yeah. We're not for letting out in situations like that. That one on DeMello was interesting. Lucic said he made eye contact
right,
with him, so I never expected him to turn back like that.
Right.
But the responsibility is on the hitter. There's a shot by Gudbranson that goes wide. Puck comes up the boards. Coleman gets a three but can't find it. Letang back on it. He'll play it near side for McGinn. Bluger had it hop away. Zadorov's there to take control. He'll bump it back into his own end as both teams make changes. Eric Gudbranson surveys. Pass tipped. Stolen by John Marino. Off the boards and out, right to Rodriguez. Quick pass for Crosby off the mark. Cleared by Calgary. Marcus Pedersen's on it. He's pressured in the corner. Falls down. Pitlick steals in front for Dubé. Can't get a shot away. Chopped wide by Monahan off the side of the goal. Pedersen knocked down by Monahan, who falls as well. Puck comes loose to Dylan Dubé. Dubé surveys. Over to Hanifin. Rister deflected, and Jari got a piece of that on the tip in front. Another good chance for Calgary. Crosby settles the puck down. Rodriguez has a chance to get it up. Plays it back to Sidney Crosby. He'll bring it in with a pass to Gensel. Rodriguez shoots. Sam Markstrom makes the save. Rodriguez Works the puck up the boards all the way back to the line. Across with a one-timer that Markstrom sees all the way and turns aside. Marino stolen by Hanifin. He'll make a long pass off for Dubé, who chases icing wave as Jari comes out to play. Puts the puck to the corner to Marino. 12 minutes to gone here in the first period of play. Zucker gets the puck up. Lindholm there. Ahead to Shillington, but couldn't take the pass. Jeff Carter checked by Lindholm, and Johnny Gaudreau gets on the puck and takes off. Here's Gaudreau! Stopped by Jari. Rebound. Carter gets it past Shillington. No icing. Puck rolling. Markstrom out to play it. Leads it for Shillington. Whips it around the boards for Tkachuk. It was tied up by Dumoulin, so no icing. Jari puts the puck to the corner to Jeff Carter. Leaving it behind the net for Chad Ruedel. One of the rare San Diego-born players in the NHL. Right. Ruedel. Here's Zadorov. Hard pass up the middle. Deflected away. Now Lafferty turns back the other way. Forced wide by Zadorov. Zadorov with a big hit on Lafferty, but he makes a play back to the line. Shot by Matheson, turned away by Markstrom. Lafferty on the rebound. Now a chance kicked away as the puck ricocheted back towards Heinen, and he was turned aside with that left pad of Markstrom. Mike Matheson on the puck. Played it out. Richardson took it away. Right back in for Calgary as that line heads off for the Flames. And on comes the back of the line, and yes, indeed, the Crosby line for Pittsburgh is the Flames get that back the unit out as often as they can against number 87. Puck tipped in. Markstrom takes a look. Has to leave it with Crosby reaching in. Loose side of the goal. And finally Wood free, and away goes Michael back with four Flames out the center. On the way to Mangiapane. Across to Coleman. Off a stick to the corner. Takes a look. Back to Hanifin. Feeds it across now to Anderson with a shot that's blocked. Mangiapane shoots, and that's off the stick with Pettersson into the corner. Anderson with a one-timer. Ricochets off a leg across to Sidney Crosby. And he'll bank it out. Right to Hanifin, though. Backlund carries in. Plays it deep. Mangiapane chases. Anderson back to it. Crosby behind the net for Marino. With 14 minutes gone. Long pass for Rodriguez. A little too far. Markstrom on the play. Hits the puck to Tanev. Beat it out. Hit leg pressure. And Dumoulin bumps it back. And Chris Letang there to take control. Across to Brian Dumoulin. Out to Jeff Carter. Hopped away from him. Pitlick ahead to Monahan. Backhands it in. Dylan Dubé on the forecheck. Dumoulin there first. Guiding around towards Kapanen. Zucker. Able to muscle the puck out. Tipped as far as the Calgary line. And Dylan Dubé back to it first. And that goes on the leg and winds up over the glass. 5:22 to go in the first. The Flames have had some looks. Tristan Jarry's been good. The latest chance for Johnny Gaudreau. And a scoreless tie on Sportsnet.
In the lineup tonight, but inching closer. This was the injury that had made sure that he had to have off-season knee surgery. He has not played a game this season, but there was encouraging signs today, actually this morning, on Saddle Dome ice with his teammates on this trip, and there he was practicing. No contact, obviously, and no timetable just yet for a return. It would be a surprise to some if it was before Christmas, but an encouraging sign nonetheless, guys.
All right, thank you. Yes, the ends on a five-game trip that starts tonight, so Malkin out with him. Getting closer.
Yep, that's great news for not only Penguins fans, but hockey fans.
Loose puck center ice, tipped to the boards by Matthew Tkachuk, fired back in by the Penguins. 5 minutes to go here in the first. Tanev, long bank pass for Tkachuk, a little too far, and that'll be an icing call on Calgary.
It's game time. Order all your favorites with Skip the Dishes. Let's get hungry.
You know, Johnny Gaudreau gets a lot of attention, a lot of talk, but his centerman, Elias Lindholm, is just playing superb hockey right now. Fantastic to watch.
He has three of their eight shots already in this game. Leads the league in plus minus, plus 18 yeah. Coming into tonight. He's been a great all-around player, centering that top line.
Right, just yep. Does everything. Not well, but almost perfectly.
Oh, and he's on a seven-game point streak.
Oh, that's it? Better pick it up a little there, bud.
Here's Crosby in, broken up by Hanifin. Tang's back to it. dumped in by Gensel. Takes a bump as he throws the puck into the Calgary zone. Hannafin ahead to Lucic. Tip to the line. Not out. Lucic, second chance. This time he clears. Got the Richardson line out there this time against Crosby and company. Although Crosby heads off on a change. Richardson with a shot that goes wide. Kluber's there and he'll clear. Batted down at center by Rodriguez. Turns to the bench. Here's a tidbit for you, Kelly.
All right.
Flames are 9-1-3 in games that follow a one-day break. So, for what that's worth.
Okay.
They've had a lot of those this year because they played a lot of games.
Yeah, you're right.
With not many days off.
But it's worked well for them.
It has, yep.
I'll score that stat later tonight, okay?
Bring it up. Mangiapane in the corner. Pressure by Ruedel. Flips a pass back to Gabranson. He takes a look. Shoots, and that's turned away. Back into the rebound. Check by Mike Matheson. And now it's Kluber on it, able to steer it off the center ice to Brock McGinn. And the puck's played in high. 3.5 left in the first period. Good Branson to Monahan. Flips the puck around the board, slowed down by Jari. Pettersson's there, pressure. Flames force a turnover. Pettersson gets it back though. Got it in front, Lafferty steered it away. And now it's Dominique Simon down the wing. Knocked off his stick, and then he's pulled over by Dubé. And it's a glove pass as Simon put it to the corner to Heinen.
Well, you have to find ways to contribute. And again, here's Dubé, and he's puck up in the air, Simon, and Dubé comes in from behind and knocks the Penguins winger down. That's nice and clean. Let's take a look at Pitlick. He has been giving Pettersson problems the entire night. By the way, that's three really good forechecks in tonight's game by Colin Pitlick. I've been really impressed with his energy on the forecheck.
Tanev whips the puck around the boards, and there's Pitlick right on cue, making a play across. Dylan Dubé to center. Back over to Pitlick, who carries in. Lost the puck just inside the line and tipped off the top of the boards, but stays in play. Markstrom to Shillington. Pitlick. Pressured by Marino. Tanev will try the other side. Ahead for Dubé. Pettersson pinches. Puck comes free to Monahan. Gets it up. Tap and it's knocked down, but the Penguins are on it. John Marino got the puck to the line. Zucker's shot deflects to Marino. He's in deep. A pass off a Calgary stick to Tkachuk. Couldn't pass out. Trying to spring to throw, but a little too far. Letang settles it down as we approach the final 2 minutes of this opening period. Fairly frantic start to this period. Things have calmed down a little in the last 5-6 minutes after a number of great chances for Calgary.
All right, let's take a look at Pitlick. There's another hit. He's going to hit Kapanen. Kapanen was in some pain when he went back to the Penguins bench. No call, of course. But you're right. I agree with you, Rick. I think it's the pace has slowed down the last 4 or 5 minutes. Just a hair, not much.
Here's Crosby, works the puck in. Shot by Gensel, glove save Markstrom, and he hangs on for a faceoff.
And one guy you have to be aware of course, Crosby, but Gensel, and he always puts himself in good shooting position. Watch how he supports a puck from Crosby. And that was labeled, by the way, that was a really quick release, and to me, he had the top corner picked on the glove side.
Gensel on a 9-game point streak coming into tonight, 5-5 in that run.
And he has scored a point in every road game this year for the Penguins.
Interesting number,
right? He has 5 goals and 5 assists in those 8 road games so far.
That was out of fine the net. I called a playoff game with him in Philadelphia a couple years ago. We had 4 goals to seal it.
You and our good friend Greg Millen were calling that series.
Greg's working in Winnipeg tonight. That's an offside call at the Calgary blue line. And Gensel's streak right now, Kelly, longest current active streak in the NHL.
Yeah, there's pretty impressive players, right? Gensel, 9 games, 10 points. Lindholm, you mentioned that streak already. And Johnny Gaudreau, 6 games, but he has 10 points in those six games.
Two helpers in that game on Saturday against Winnipeg.
That was a well-played game by Calgary, even though they lost. Those are you're going to have some of those. I thought Hellebuck really was the star of that game, but Flames jump out to a 2-0 lead, which they've been doing, as you and I have mentioned a number of times already. But I give Winnipeg a lot of credit for hanging in there.
Here's Zadorov back on the puck. Minute and a half to go in the period. Cut off on the far side by McGinn. Plays the puck to the corner. Played out front by Aston Reese. That's knocked down to the side of the goal by Markstrom. Ruedel will try and flip it down the boards. Cut off by Coleman. They're all tangled up. Penalty coming up to Coleman, I think. Or maybe it's Ruedel. I don't know. Pittsburgh had the puck. And Ruedel looks a little baffled. The puck, his stick looked like it got right caught in Coleman, so it might be a hooking call in the Penguins defenseman, Kelly.
Well, he, Ruedel skating towards the bench, he's puzzled as to, and now Sidney Crosby's arguing it with the official. And you can see there's, well, Coleman certainly grabs a stick, but also after Coleman grabs the stick of Ruedel, the defenseman's stick comes up. So you could argue the case that both players should receive a penalty.
Yeah, I think it's the high stick. You're right at the end there, but Coleman did get away with a grab
he
on the
clearly grabbed the stick, right?
Yep.
And so that's what Crosby's arguing. Now the all four officials are going to have a little conversation about this play.
So Ian Walsh, Kevin Pollock are your referees.
Watch the left hand of Coleman. Right there, he grabs a stick, and now the stick of the defenseman comes up. So this is going to be interesting what they... And now... Let's see.
That's Ian Walsh, number 29. Looks like he's going to sort this out and make the call here.
Calgary, number 20, holding the stick. Pittsburgh, minor penalty, high sticking.
All right.
Okay, great.
And that's the right call.
That's the right call. I love that.
Where they play Coleman doesn't think
so. Yeah, he doesn't think so, and I understand that as well, but that is exactly how this system is intended to work. They have a little conversation. It doesn't take up too much time in the game, and you get the call right.
It's interesting on offsetting minors to see both guys look equally perplexed.
Right.
But okay. I think it's the right call.
Here's another look, and you'll see with the left hand, Coleman is going to grab the stick. That's obvious, as is the high stick. So good job by the officials. Hey, they're both like, oh, that's funny.
So 4-on-4, here's a chance, shot, stop, nice pass, save off Gensel, play back in front by Ruedel, and that's knocked aside. Flames are on it, tipped away, but Hanifin there to take control, right to the final minute of play in the opening period. Michael Backlund will bring it out, carries in, slows it down, shoots wide, puck around, Hanifin pitching. Back down low for Backlund, but it's picked off by Letang. Pressure, it's stolen. In front, stop, rebound, tip line by Backlund. Another chance at a rebound that just misses. First shot was by Mangiapane. Boy, the Flames have had some opportunities here. Jari's been outstanding in this opening period.
He sure has.
Anderson's back on it, 20 seconds to go. Rasmus Anderson retreats back to the line. Feeds it down low. Hanifin tips it off the side of the post. Puck to the corner. Gensel's been out for a while, so has Crosby, and he'll take his time and bump it back. Or it's controlled by Letang, and he'll watch the final seconds wind down as the first period comes to an end, but not without Calgary getting two more great scoring chances in the final minute.
But not before Pittsburgh had a chance. Watch Crosby to Dumoulin. He gets a pass to Gensel, the most dangerous player on the Penguins. And then Letang makes another mistake. That's his third big mistake this period. Goes right in front, and then Mangiapane gets a great chance. Backlund can't bury the rebound, but Jari, Rick, as you mentioned, has been the story of this first period. He's been spectacular. 10 great saves for the Penguins.
All right, Brian Burke will be Ryan Leslie's guest, now the director of hockey operations for the Pittsburgh Penguins, coming up after Sportsnet Central update. All that in the first intermission after a scoreless opening 20 minutes in Calgary.
Update, a lot of changes in Montreal's front office upstairs, so they're hoping some of those changes, although very fresh, will translate perhaps on the ice tonight.
Yeah, they're not. Mark Bergevin has fired on Sunday. Out as GM, and the Habs are taking on the Canucks tonight.
Yep.
Let's face it, both teams, you know, not exactly Stanley Cup contenders.
Six wins each.
Bottom five in the standings. Canadians one more loss than the Canucks in Montreal. They fired Marc Bergevin on Sunday, and they do not come out flying at all. At one point in the first period, shots on goal were 12-1 for Vancouver. This is the 12th shot. Elias Pettersson on the power play beats Jake Allen. Snaps a 9-game goalless drought. 1-0 Vancouver. Late in the period, well, the Habs starting to come along. Shots on goal 12-9, making 12-10. Ryan Poehling in tight. Redirects it home. Tie game. 1-1. We go to the second. Josh Anderson, he of the turnover. Bo Horvat. Oh, bad turnover. Right in front for Connor Garland. Upstairs, his second goal in as many games. 2-1. Canucks. Can Montreal come back again? Thatcher Demko, how about the stop on Cole Caulfield? Habs down by one. Right about now, your score is still 2-1 Canucks in the third.
All right, let's go to Winnipeg. It's the Jets hosting the Coyotes. First period, Blake Wheeler shoots, and Karel Vemelka. Is that how I say it, Kenny?
Karel Vemelka. I love that name.
He gets a piece, puck bounces on top of the goal, eventually cleared away. Wheeler still looking for his first goal of the season. Second period, zeros. Oh. Nick Ehlers on the rush, gets past the defender, tries for the wraparound, but cannot wrap it fully around. Not happy. Later in the frame, Louis Erickson centers to Anton Roussel and does get it by Connor Hellebuck for his third. Coyotes, they have the 1-0 lead, even though they were outshot 32-12 through 40 minutes. Yeah, shots favoring the Jets 43-15 right now, but still about down by goal.
Hey, it's the seventh suspension of Brad Marchand's career. He gets 3 games for this slew foot on Oliver Ekman-Larsson on Sunday. Get this, Marchand can come back when the Bruins play the Canucks on December 8th. So if you add up all the suspensions and fines that Marchand has had over the years, he has forfeited over $971,000 in salary. That's a lot of cash. That's almost $1 million that he just threw away. But maybe he made some room for himself out on the ice. I guess that's one way you can look at it, right?
I guess.
Or you can look at it as cost yourself almost $1 million.
Almost $1 million.
Right?
There you go.
But maybe it's an investment room. I don't know. Tomato, tomato, Ozmak. She's
not
got
anymore?
Nothing.
It's nope. This turtleneck brings out the smarts in you, this financial advisor role. But anyway, we'll see you after second period.
Back to the Scotiabank Saddledome. No score after 20 minutes. A few moments ago, I caught up with Elias Lindholm. Well, Elias, you've all kinds of chances for your group in the first 20. What did you make of the first period for your group?
No, I thought we came out good. Had a lot of chances, like you said, and just got to put them in, especially me.
You've got a goaltender there at the other end who's playing pretty good. I don't know what you noticed. You mentioned, especially you had some chances there as well. So what's it going to take to beat this guy? I don't know if you want to change much, but how do you see it?
No, you know, for myself, keep shooting. We're going to go in sooner or later. And obviously, the one I shot it wide and could have done a better job there. But the one he made a nice save on, and just got to keep shooting, and we'll go in sooner or later.
Appreciate the time. Good luck in the second. Okay, very pleased to welcome in the president of hockey operations for the Pittsburgh Penguins, Brian Burke, stopping by. Berkey, first of all, welcome back. A little weird coming back to a game here at the old Scotiabank Saddledome for you.
It's wonderful to be back. What a great building, great fans, and I had a great time here.
What stands out for you in your time here? I know you had such great relationships, not only within the team, but certainly throughout the organization and certainly in the community. But what stands out for you about your time in the same role here?
I never worked at a place where they spent more time and more effort on the community than they did in Calgary. Everyone I met worked for the mustard seed or worked for, you know, Special Olympics. The support in the community and altruistic and philanthropic functions is unreal. So that was the thing I enjoyed the most.
I know you had a chance to chat with Brad Treliving last night. I don't know what you can share with us. Just about comparing notes about the way you do things in the East, about how things are going here. What was some of that conversation like?
Well, you get spoiled when you work in the East in terms of travel. You know, what we consider was a real tough travel day yesterday was 5 hours with the headwinds. But, you know, you're used to that out West a lot more than you are in the East. So that's the number one thing is the travel.
Do you miss the Sportsnet side of things? Do you miss this TV business?
I'm really happy to be back on the team side. I enjoyed working in TV, enjoyed it very much. Enjoyed working for Sportsnet and Hockey Night, but very happy to get back on the team side with the Penguins.
Hey, let's get to the news of the day, and that is new ownership for the Pittsburgh Penguins. You have been, as an organization, so blessed to have Mary Lemieux and so many others involved, and now you've got the Fenway Sports Group on board. Just tell us what that means. I know you spoke with the players about it this morning, but what does it overall mean to the organization?
Well, first off, the fact that Mario and Ron are staying in is big for us. They're really important to us. But the ownership group, the Fenway Sports Group, is a big-time organization with major league assets, major league backing, and we're really excited about the chance to work with the Fenway Sports Group. So this isn't a bad day from our perspective. It's a great day. We're excited about them. Obviously, they own the Boston Red Sox. They own Liverpool. They own the Fenway Roush Racing Group and NASCAR. So these are people that have been involved in sports, deep pockets, real good brains. And we're excited about working with them.
I know how excited you were to join this organization as well. I know you're very fond of ownership and the relationships that you knew existed. But I think, if I'm not mistaken, you and Ron Hextall didn't have a lot of history. What's that dynamic been like working together with
well,
Ron?
Well, I study people, so I didn't work with Ron much, but I've studied him for years. He's very thoughtful, very careful in how he speaks, really a sharp hockey guy. But what I like most about him is he's thoughtful. He thinks things through and has a result, has a plan all the time, and I like that the best about him.
You get some good news today, encouraging, I should say, when you see Evgeny Malkin back on the ice with your team. That's a surgery that he hasn't obviously played any games this season, but what does that mean to this group? And certainly overall, a player of his caliber starting to take strides to getting closer.
Well, he's a very positive influence. He brought a lot of juice to our team today just being out there. He's still a ways away. He's not close to playing. He's still a ways away, but just his presence out there gave us a lift. He's an elite player. He's a great kid, and it was really nice to see him out there, even though, like I say, let's not get carried away here. This guy's still got some time to go.
Right. Maybe if there's something you could share with us that you've learned about working alongside Sidney Crosby, maybe that you didn't know or maybe we wouldn't know.
Well, it's just reinforced everything. This guy works so hard, and he works on very fine points in the game, his edge work, with little stick moves. Like, I've never seen a better or deeper student of the game. And then he drives practice with his heart, with his work ethic. He works like a dog, so it's been a joy to have him.
Wanted to ask you if you could put your director of player safety hat on for just a moment and get your reaction to the incident between Brendan Lemieux and Brady Tkachuk, accusations of biting. What was your takeaway on that, and how would you see this unfolding?
Well, the fact that they called an in-person hearing indicates to me that they're going to take a hard look at this. And I think it's going to be a substantial suspension is my guess. I don't know, and I don't want to color things before they reach fruition here, but there's no place in the game for biting people. We know that. So I'm guessing they're going to look hard at this and come down hard on this.
Hey, it is a Flames broadcast. I know you're the competition tonight, but I know you're also very close with how things go here. So what's your impression of what's going on with Calgary right now? They've gotten off to a great start, Berkey, and that's just something that they've desperately needed in recent years.
Yeah, they had a good start. They've had the first goal in most games. They had a good start tonight. We were ragged at the start. We settled down and played pretty even after that. They've done a good job here. They've got a good team. They've got a great goaltender. They got a great coach. So do we.
Listen, as always, we appreciate the time. It's great to see you back here. Best of luck throughout the rest of this season.
Thanks, Ryan.
All right, there he is, Brian Burke, the president of hockey operations for the Pittsburgh Penguins. No score after 20 here in Calgary. Second period around the corner. Stay with us.
Off here at Scotiabank Saddledome, Rick Ball with Kelly Rudy in the broadcast booth. Well, the Flames had their chances in that first period. Jari was good. Your thoughts on that opening 20 minutes, Kelly?
Not surprised the Flames came out strong again. That seems to be the way in which they play or start every single game this season. And as you mentioned, Jari was terrific. I thought that the Flames probably should have had something like a 3-0 lead. Although I will say for Pittsburgh, I thought the last 5 minutes of that period, they started their legs a little bit, right? So that's kind of what I expected, you know, coming on the start of this five-game road trip, as you mentioned. Sometimes it can be slow out of the gates, and that's what I thought happened to Pittsburgh.
All right, Crosby out to start against Backlund again, like they did the first period, and middle frame is underway. Anderson has the puck. He'll bank it around to his partner, Noah Hanifin. Back to Anderson. Out to Mangiapane, intercepted by Crosby. He'll give it to Gensel, and Gensel works the puck in with speed. Hanifin watching him as they go in deep. Anathan pushes Gensel off the puck. Backlund winds up with control with a play across that Anderson skates onto and dumps into the zone. Hang back. Stolen. Backlund in front looking for Shillington, but he moved over and it goes past him and all the way down the ice. Here's Tanev. Quick up. Finds Lindell and tipped it over to Shillington. That was off the mark and would have been offside anyway. So Shillington backs out as Matheson controls and makes a play to Jeff Carter. Carter in with a shot and he whistled that wide. Planks it off the glass. Picked up down low. Fed back. Here's a shot. Stopped by Markstrom is leading into that one was Matheson. Now a long pass for Coleman who was behind everybody. That's broken up at center ice by the Penguins who dodge a bullet there as Coleman might have been walking in home free. Swatted down at the line by Tanev. Settled down now by Kapanen. He'll put it in deep for Carter. Tanev on him. Zucker into the play. Can't shake Shillington. Zucker falls. Tanev gets control. Kachuk bumps it back, and here goes Lindholm through center. Lies Lindholm in to Gaudreau. Gaudreau looks, shoots, hit the post. Right off the iron, glove side on Jari. Penguins on the loose puck. Zucker's able to get it up. And he'll flip it down the ice too hard. That'll be an icing call on Pittsburgh and a chance, Kelly, for us to look at that goalpost by Johnny Gaudreau.
Let's take a look at a first good chance, although he doesn't hit the net, but Jeff Carter, typical up there. Excuse me, we're going to see Johnny Gaudreau first. Rips that off the crossbar. Let's take a look one more time. Johnny gets all of this, rips it past Jari, but can't beat the post. But there was a chance that Jeff Carter had before that, Rick, that I... Yep. Penguins, good start.
Off the drop, puck battle in the corner, up the boards, and cleared out by Kasperi Kapanen. Pittsburgh able to change now after that icing call. Is back onto it for Calgary. It's Tyler Pitlick. Brings it through center, banks it in. Roller, swept back towards the line, not out. Flames trying to force a turnover. McGinn settles it down for Pittsburgh. And he'll feed it around behind the net to Chad Ruedel. Teddy Bluger with a long pass out. Here's McGinn in with Aston Reese, but good play by Zadorov to knock the puck away. Brad Richardson puts the puck to the line. One-handed in by Pitlick at the end of his shift. Jari leaves it for Mike Matheson. And he'll skate the puck forward and fire a pass to Bluger, who steers it in. Cut off by McGinn. Zach Aston Reese checked. Anderson leans into Bluger. And makes a pass to the line, bounces back to Richardson. He'll leave it for Hanifin. Out the center for Lewis, Trevor Lewis. With the soft dump it, Lucic on the forecheck. Marino sees him coming and charges the hit, and Lucic winds up pawing hard into the boards. Now Lucic wasn't letting up on that one.
He was
John
not.
Marino made the right play. He drove away. Tanev, Coleman. Blake Coleman cuts to the middle with a shot. And that deflects high off the glass and winds up going out of play.
All right, so Lucic talked about making eye contact with DeMello. And let's take a look if Marino makes eye contact. Yes, indeed. There's the eye contact. Marino sees him all the way and gets out of the way and then makes a pretty good play. Backhanding the puck behind his net. That's kind of how it's supposed to work, right?
Well, and Lucic talked about a kill. He realized, okay, he knows I'm coming,
right?
So I'm not going to let up. And earlier we saw him on McGinn, who didn't see him coming.
Absolutely.
Right? So.
That, my friend, is some good television.
And now we get a whistle. And did Coleman glove the puck back? I'm not sure, but either way, the play was stopped.
I believe the official just lost sight of the puck. So the puck is behind the net. There's Coleman battling for it. Comes loose, and yeah, as soon as it's along the netting, the referee had lost sight of it, and that's a smart play. He has to blow that down.
Backlund against Crosby, at least for now, not for long. As Backlund's tossed, Mangiapane steps in. Crosby wins the faceoff. Chad Ruedel gets the puck. Crosby checked with the line by Hanifin. Played it offside. Pens have the tag up. Hanifin has time and brings the puck out. Skates to center, lifts it high into the zone. Matheson goes back. Rasmus Anderson keeps the play onside and puts it in deep for Andrew Mangiapane, trying to get a quick pass in front. Partially fanned on, but Coleman fights to get it back. Anderson shoots, kicked away by Jari. Bounces all the way back. Hanifin Had that ricochet off the leg of Rodriguez back to the Calgary zone. Flames have control. Backlund ahead to Coleman. Now Tkachuk into the play. The Flames start a change. Tkachuk one hands the puck in front of the goal. Bluger broke it up. He falls. Gensel's on it. Puts it back in behind to Ruedel. Stolen by Zadorov, but it got away. Hopped over a stick last second. Rodriguez trying to get after it. Zadorov comes back to take it away. Hassled, but able to make a pass over to Lindholm. Johnny Gaudreau back on the ice. Finds Lindholm on the wing to Tkachuk. Banks it ahead to Lindholm. Back to the line. Zadorov put shot wide. Gudbranson hustling over. Puts the puck in deep for Tkachuk. Put it in front. Nobody there for Calgary. Bounce it. Lindholm's on it. Here's Tkachuk again in behind. Rolling puck knocked off the stick by Letang, but Tkachuk gets it back to Gaudreau. Here's Lindholm. Stopped again by Jarry. Another good look for Lindholm and another good save by Tristan Jarry. As McGinn backhands the puck into the Calgary zone and wholesale changes for Pittsburgh. 5 minutes gone here in the second. Pitlick tips the puck to the line. Knocked down by Pedersen and cleared out the center ice. Pitlick's back on it. Stunt puts it high into the zone. Bounces for the corner. Pedersen there. Popped it up. Monahan works the puck back towards the near side. Put it in front. Dubé shot blocked. Here's Pitlick in front to Dubé and he couldn't quite reach it. Hanna tries a shot. Jarry cuts that off and is able to cover up for a faceoff and more pressure by the Calgary Flames.
And more stellar play by Tristan Jarry. Let's take a look at a point shot with traffic. Rasmus Anderson. Jarry makes a nice save and then seconds later Lindholm's going to get an opportunity right in the slot. He gets the pass from Johnny Gaudreau. Watch this quick release from Jarry. Up to the task again. Now, Rick, you and I had a quick conversation with Brian Burke after his interview with Brian Leslie, and he was telling us that this is how Jari's been the entire season, although he did say he's had a couple of average games, but the best thing about that young kid is that he forgets it really quick.
Short memory. Here's Tanev, shoots and that's blocked. It went off the skate of Lafferty, but the Flames deny an exit. Richardson gets the puck towards the goal, shot it just wide. Shillington over to it. Plays it to the high slot, winds up in the corner. Here's Lewis back to Tanev, in deep now for Richardson. Lucic is in front. Richardson being pressured, knocked down by Marino. Puck play back around for Tanev. Drops it off of the line for Lewis. In deep for Lucic. Lucic. Here's Lewis, shoots, and that whistles wide. Tanev. Good pressure by the Flames' fourth line here. Lewis. Lucic back at the point. He'll whip it all the way around for Tanev. Penguins tired on this shift. Tanev pumps it back. Shillington hustles over. Got to it just in time. Flipped it down the board. Simone check. Coleman trying to get there. Richardson leans on Matheson. He tries to tie it up along the boards. Now his teammates to catch their breath. Matheson knocks it free. And now Simone has a chance to bring it out. Makes a play out to Heinen. He'll bank it in. And Pittsburgh will start a change. 6.5 minutes gone here in the second period. Mangiapane in with speed. Slows it down in the circle. As he spins. Threw it across. Looking for Backlund. That's picked off by Letang. And he throws it out to Kapanen. In on a 2-on-1 with Carter. Kapanen to Carter. Pass blocked neatly by Gudbranson. Zadorov comes back to help out. Puts it ahead to Tkachuk. All the way across to Mangiapane. He'll work the puck in slowly. Drop it off for Gudbranson. Tkachuk's in front. Pass didn't get there. It's deflected up into the face of Letang, who knocks it down. And then Carter shovels the puck up the boards and out. Kapanen check, but got it to the Calgary line. Gaudreau bumps it back to Zadorov. He fires a pass to Tkachuk, steered it in with his foot. Letang's on it for Pittsburgh. And makes a play to Kasperi Kapanen. Pedersen feeds it ahead. Zucker back to Pedersen. Back to Zucker. Gudbranson pokes at the puck, comes back to the point. Tkachuk there to feed it out, just out of the reach of Gaudreau. And it's intercepted by Marcus Pedersen. He flips it in. There's Noah Hanifin. Crosby watching him. Rodriguez steals. Batted away. Tkachuk finally gets control, brings it out with Gaudreau, takes the pass. Late in the shift, trying to swing wide, can't get the puck in deep. One handed out by Hanifin, loose at center ice. Pedersen plays it across to Crosby, but Rodriguez caught offside. And the whistle blows with 12:08 to go here in the second period. Flames have had some chances in the offensive zone and some good plays in their own end. As Gudbranson blocks that pass to keep this game scoreless.
Congratulations, and thanks for helping us out. But the pizza's gonna be great pizza, Brock.
a look at Noah Hanifin. Some routine plays that catch the eye and some plays that maybe catch the eye of the coach. Tonight, just a moment ago, you saw him in what might be a routine play, but very responsible. And take you back to Saturday with the intricacies of the game. Maybe one that maybe did catch the eye and some others. It was a giveaway that led to an opportunity for Winnipeg to get a scoring chance, and that would catch the coach's eye, and maybe that turnover would get a coach fired up, but it was fired up in a positive way. Maybe something you don't always see, but Darryl just seems to know when to be positive. And the very next shift, it would result in another subtle play that was getting it out of the zone. It would turn into something for Calgary. And just time and time again, you kind of surprised at the way Darryl can get these guys going in different ways, gentlemen.
All right, Ryan, thank you. There's a scramble in front of Jari again. Loose puck. Side of the goal. Flames pressing for the first goal of the game, but that pass misses Hanifin, and he'll chase it back into his own zone. Dumped back in by the Pens. Anderson's there. Hanifin, long pass, finds Coleman. Tips the puck in, but wrong side of center. And that's an icing call on Calgary.
Well, Coleman's had an energetic night. He's all around it also. Take a look at the hard work here in on the forecheck. Gets past Crosby, then out muscles Marino and gets a great chance on the wraparound. That's exactly what Kirk Muller was talking about on the forecheck. And Blake Coleman, excellent effort. By the way, I thought he was fantastic on After Hours with Scott and Cassie on Saturday. And by the way, I loved his answers, but that jacket was sharp. It looked fantastic. I loved it.
Yeah, I don't comment on anybody's clothes.
Sounded good, but he looked better, right, Rick?
Well, it's better to look good than feel good, I think Billy Crystal once said on Saturday Night Live many years ago.
Right.
There's a good reference from the 80s for the kids.
Yeah, Blake Coleman, boy, he has just brought it every single game. Yesterday was his birthday, so happy birthday.
Turned the big 3-0.
Mm-hmm. But that, you get an honest effort from him, right?
Yeah. Now you know what you're going to get on number 20 for sure. But the guys the Flames have added this season with Stanley Cup experience, you know, and
yeah,
and what a difference that makes. You bring Coleman, and he's got a couple. You bring Lewis, and he's got a couple. You know, Lucic already here has one. It's one of those intangibles, but you can't help but think that if the Flames make the playoffs this year, that experience is going to help for sure.
Yeah. Now, I did bring up the jacket on purpose on Saturday because there's, you know, when you join a city like this, you understand the importance of Hockey Night in Canada and After Hours.
Yeah.
And he took the time to dress up, to look sharp. And, you know, you don't get a lot of time after the game, right? I understand he also had some medical stuff that he had to take care of also. And so it was really important, some, I guess, dental work. And so I just, that really stood out for a guy like myself that has been on After Hours for years and years as one of the hosts. It really stood out to me, the importance of what he feared.
I still like his, him and his wife's Halloween costume. They went full Canadian. He had the plaid shirt, the Mounties hat. And she dressed up as a Coleman cooler, which makes perfect sense.
Oh, that's fantastic.
9 minutes gone here in the second period. There's Jeff Carter. Put the puck to the corner. Tanev chops at it. Knocked away from him. He lost his stick as Carter gets the puck back with a play to the line to Chad Ruedel with a long shot. Deflected it! That might have caught the post. Or Markstrom got a piece of it, but it came out like it went off the iron behind potentially. Close call there as the Pens look to draw first blood on this one. Here's Carter. Works the puck towards the corner. Feeds it around. Picked off by Richardson. Ahead to Lewis. Can't get it out. Knocked away by Matheson. Tanev resets. Plays it over, and Shillington feeds the puck out to Lucic. Chips it away. That's a bit of room. Here's Lucic. Shoots. Scores! Well, that's his sixth of the season, and Milan Lucic makes it 1-0 Calgary.
And this is set up because of another important save by Jacob Markstrom. Ruedel with a nice pass, and watching it. Really clever deflection by Zucker that gets Markstrom on the mask, and all of a sudden, now Ruedel is going to make a bad play on Lucic at center ice. Watch the body position by Lucic. He just puts a pass in defensive, and where does he go? 5-goal. 3 of his 6 goals this year, Rick, have been 5-goal, including one on October 28th versus Pittsburgh in Pittsburgh.
So he got that 5-minute major, got tossed from the game a couple nights ago, and we're not happy about that call, but comes out tonight with a lot of energy and gets Calgary on the board. 18th time in 22 games the Flames have scored first. That is one of the more incredible stats you'll ever see.
Sure is. Now, if I'm the opposition, I'm going to tell my goaltenders, listen, if Lucic has an opportunity, you might want to cover the 5-ball.
Just, if nothing else, just do that. Force him to shoot somewhere else. Midway through the second period, we finally have a goal in this one. Letang fumbled the pass, and away go the Flames. Dubé and Pitlick 2-on-2. Now Monahan joins the rush. Dubé force wide. Can't keep the play outside. Letang, who gave the puck away, bails himself out and chops the puck to center ice. Shillington and Tanev get the assist on the Lucic goal. Rasmus Anderson, that popped over his stick. Played back to Rodriguez, the top line off for Pittsburgh, looking to answer back. Hannafin in the corner. Ahead to Tkachuk, he'll feed it over to Gaudreau. And puck winds up at center, but Crosby's there. Has to wait for Rodriguez to tag up. Now Gensel gets the puck. And knocked away from him. Checked neatly by Lindholm. Banked around for Hannafin. Too far. Crosby got it across. Marino intercepted by Lindholm. Ahead to Gaudreau. Turning. Tkachuk breaking in, and he can't quite drag the back leg. He would have had a step two, but Gaudreau didn't see him, and they wind up going offside. 8:54 to go in the second. Milan Lucic puts one behind Jari. Love the celebration. 1-0 Calgary on Sportsnet.
Two goals on Pittsburgh, 5 goals, so let's go back a month. This is Lucic with his first of the season back in Pittsburgh, and he goes 5-hole on Casey DeSmith. You fast forward tonight, Lucic gets a great opportunity. 5-hole on Tristan Jarry. You look at the scoring for the Flames. And man alive, they've had a lot of secondary scoring. We'll show you a graphic here that will prove that shortly.
Scored a 5-0 goal in Jersey, too, and that's it. Ultra. Similar play. Here's Shillington. Passing. Tanev off the boards. Plays the puck. Into the corner. Shillington's in deep. In front. There's Coleman with a shot. Jarry save. Rebound. Put back the puck before it got to Mangiapane. Zucker was able to break it up on a nice play defensively. Mangiapane waiting for that pass on the back door. Would have had a tap in. Here's Coleman. Pass blocked. Coleman back in the battle, but Letang cuts it off. Flips it up. Zucker trying to break through. Ran into Shillington, but Shillington able to make a play from one knee and find Backlund. Fires a pass over to Coleman. Puts a shot wide. Backlund. Checked along the boards by Dumoulin, but fights to get the puck back. Coleman didn't see it. Carter took it away. Capping it in. Slows it down. Makes a pass. Letang in front. Nice stop by Markstrom off Simone, who took that setup from Letang and had a good look. And now Coleman has been up for a while, puts it off the glass into the Pittsburgh zone and heads off on a change. Marino fires a pass to Hine and he'll wheel through center. Gain the zone, tries a shot, and stopped by Markstrom. Puck comes back to Hine. Lost it for a moment. Flames are on it. Pass hits Tkachuk, bounces up. Matheson chips it across to Lafferty, who whips it back in. Anderson. A pass up the middle right to Tkachuk, and he finds Gaudreau, who takes off down the wing. Drops it off to Tkachuk, turning inside the line. D changing, so plays it deep for Gaudreau. Trying to kick it up to his stick, which is tied up by Lafferty. Now it's not free. Tkachuk able to get in the corner with a play to Lindholm. Turning, passing, Gabranson shoots, and stopped by Jarry. Lafferty on the rebound. 17th shot by the Flames in this game as the puck flipped up. And Zadorov's back on it. Lucic on the ice. Squats it in. Jarry leaves the puck. Matheson plays it up the boards. Gensel flips the puck to the line. Rodriguez takes control and dumps it in. Zadorov, Richardson, Lucic steers the puck in past Letang. He lets Lucic go get it. Lewis flips the puck all the way around to Shillington. He winds up and shoots, and that deflected wide. Tanev tipped away from him, but he tied up the stick of Crosby enough to get the puck back and flip it in.
And it's a good thing he did tie up the stick of Crosby because it was 2-on-1.
There's Crosby reaching back and sweeping it up past Tanev, and he'll chase back with Evan Rodriguez in pursuit. Shillington to Dubé. Pass to Tanev. Three Flames over the line, and the pass tip just onside. Pitlick shoots, glove by Jari. He hangs on. Just under 6 minutes to go. Second period, Eric Johansson looking for the second goal by the Flames. Shut down by Jari. Calgary up 1-0.
Front to Mangiapane. Zucker to great play. Now take a look at Simone with the middle lane drive to get the pass from Letang. Markstrom with a terrific save. Let's take a look at this save one more time. Fantastic play by Markstrom. Now take a look at the pass from Lindholm through Simone right onto the tape of Gabranson, and that's why he's able to get that opportunity.
He keeps it off in his own zone with a pass to back and off his foot. Penguins flip it in. There's Gabranson taking control. 5.5 left here in the second. Mangiapane steers it out. Kasperi Kapanen retreats with the puck and gives it to Brian Dumoulin. Banks it ahead to Teddy Bluger. Pumped by Zadorov as he dumps the puck in. Zach Aston Reese pressuring Gabranson. Mangiapane takes the puck. He'll bring it out. Make a pass for Gaudreau. Wheeling down the wing. Gaudreau cuts in deep with a shot. Up high on Jari. Fights that off with the shoulder. Here's Gaudreau again. Banked out as he lost control. Gaudreau was working on a Mike Matheson, a former Boston College teammate of his on that rush. A long pass finds Tkachuk. Tipped the puck in, taken away by Matheson, trying to shake Gaudreau. Carter gets away from Tkachuk and finds a bit of room down the wing. Jeff Carter shooting, and that's turned aside by Mark Stribben. On the rebound is Lindholm out at center ice. Runs the puck around the boards. Johnny Gaudreau gets the puck loose to Tkachuk, feeds it over. Hannafin shoots, stopped by Jari out at the top of the crease to challenge and make the save on that play. Rasmus Anderson. Tkachuk. Here's Lindholm on the attack with a shot. It's turned aside by Jari. It's the fifth shot of the game by Lindholm. Good save on those shots by Jari. As we approach the final 4 minutes of the period. Dumped in by Pittsburgh. Shillington back to it. Tanev gets the puck ahead to Trevor Lewis. His pass picked off by Rodriguez. Has to wait. Lewis lost his stick. Picks it up, but the puck goes back to Patterson. Dumped in by Letang, and that'll be an icing call on Pittsburgh.
Well, Johnny Gaudreau is going to get another good opportunity. Watch how he picks up this pass from Mangiapane. Behind him, goes through his feet, really, and he's able to control that rolling puck and get around his former teammate Matheson and still get a good high shot on Jari. You know, that's just spectacular footwork by Johnny Gaudreau. I think you might overlook that just a little bit, but how it went literally right through his feet and is able to keep that concentration.
Puck battle off the draw. Lewis off the post. Second goal post of this period for Calgary. And this time it was Trevor Lewis who let it go. The puck winds up out of play.
And this is just a really good effort by Brad Richardson on the faceoff. And he just continues to fight. Beats Rodriguez to the puck, gets it to Lewis. And that's the second post of the second period by the Flames. What an effort by Brad Richardson to stay on that puck. And Lewis with a quick release.
Interesting, we've seen a lot of Backlund's line against Crosby, but Daryl Sutter not afraid to put this Richardson line out against the Crosby line. He's done it a few times in this game.
Isn't that a luxury when you play your fourth line against somebody like Crosby's line?
And here's Lucic. Trying to muscle a puck loose, but it's scooped up by Patterson into Crosby. Knocked off his stick, Richardson will clear. Letang back on it. Bounces to Jari. Flames are offside. They're changing anyway. There's Letang up the middle to Rodriguez. Feeds it in for Gensel, speeding in. Around to Crosby. Lets it go back to the point, but Dumoulin couldn't get there in time. Ruweedle ahead to Gensel, who tipped the puck in the end of his shift. Anderson whips it up the boards. Dumoulin cut it off. Right back down low. Comes in front to Markstrom, who takes no chances.
All right, we saw Milan Lucic score his sixth of the year. Let's take a look at that depth scoring that we were talking about. No question, that top line and the second line, number of goals. Fourth line already 10 goals. Monahan and Dubé each have two. Pitlick, I wanted to mention, he has no goals right now. but he is still contributing in other ways. That's why I made mention of his great forecheck, but that is a really important secondary scoring.
Well, for Lucic, you know, last year, Kelly, was his most productive season in 3 years. He had 23 points, 10 goals. He's right. Already on pace this year for over 20 goals if he keeps this up. He's really out of his game against us coming to Calgary after a couple of tough seasons his last 2 years in Edmonton.
Not after that we've identified five goals.
Yeah, you've given away a secret. Here's Coleman bumping it back. Backlund shoots, and that misses. Puck around the boards. Branson took a hit from Lafferty and jarred the puck 3-2. Heinen, who takes off. Feeds it in for Simone, trying to get through. Simone! Stopped by Markstrom. Got in deep. Markstrom laid down that right pad and made the save. Well, Dominic Simone's had a couple of looks here. Markstrom's had the answer. Simone has one goal this season. He didn't get any points at all in his 11 games in Calgary last year. There's a steal by Gaudreau. And Brad Morlin will be fanning the shot. Shillington gets it back to Gaudreau. Leaves it for Shillington. And now Mangiapane. Tanev. Plays it deep for Lindholm. It's leaned on by Matheson. Marino trying to fish it out. He does, but stolen momentarily by Tkachuk. Marino got it back, and Lafferty's able to clear it. As we're inside the final 2 minutes. Period two, long pass to Gaudreau. Works it down his off wing. Now Tkachuk slows it down in the circle with a shot off the shoulder of Jari. Tkachuk gets the rebound. Here's Gaudreau. Threw it in front. Intercepted by Bluger. And carried out by Zach Aston-Reese. Begin with the dump in. Aston-Reese in the forecheck. Hand it back. Bluger trying to fish it out. Tanev has it pinned to the boards with his foot. Referee Kevin Pollock right there telling Bluger they finally do. Nice play by Lindholm to get the puck loose to Shillington. We hit the final minute of play in the second. Aston-Reese popped it up. Flames are changing. Had to be careful. Didn't get caught with too many men as the puck came right back to Gaudreau in front of his own bench. He heads off now. It over to Anderson. As he skates it out, Rasmus Anderson fires it deep. Letang, Rodriguez, feeds it across. Here goes Pettersson. Carries in. Gensel gets it back to Rodriguez with a shot. Off the mask of Markstrom, who fights that one off. And now Monahan heads up ice. Sean Monahan with Dubé. Monahan slows it down and puts the puck in deep. Pitlick goes to it. 15 seconds left. Puts it in behind. Letang chips it ahead. And Gensel gets it out to Rodriguez across the Crosby, but it's batted away by Anderson. Played back in, and that'll do it for the second period. So the Flames, as we mentioned, for the 18th time in 22 games, score first and have a 1-0 lead.
More scoring chances both sides. Take a look at Simone gets through Backlund and Coleman, and that is just a fantastic save by Markstrom. Let's take a look at that save one more time. Forget about style, it's all desperation at this point. Matthew Tkachuk gets a good chance. He uses Matheson as a screen. This is a great save by Jari to fight this one off. That was labeled for the top corner. And then Rodriguez gets the final good chance right off the mask. Second time Markstrom's been hit in the mask in this second period. Terrific action at both ends.
Milan Lucic with the only goal so far in this game. Corey Sarge coming up with Ryan Leslie after Sportsnet Central with Canada Vanka next. Moments ago, I caught up with the goal scorer, Milan Lucic. Milan, three of your six goals have come by way of the five-hole. NHL goalies, nobody's figured you out yet.
You know what? I just it's kind of all the same play too, and coming with speed down the left wing. And you know, even if you miss those ones, they're a high percentage shot for a rebound and stuff. But thankfully, this year they've seemed to all go in.
Just a thought on maybe how important it is for your group. I think it's the 18th time in 22 games that you've gotten on the board first as a group. Just what does that do for your group, the confidence and momentum?
Oh, it's huge. You know, it's obviously, like you just said, confidence, momentum. You play with more confidence when you have the lead. So we've, you know, you brought up the stat. We've obviously done a great job of that this year, and we've set ourselves up, you know, having a lead here going into the third, and that's, you know, that's a good feeling to have.
Appreciate the time. Good luck in that third.
All right, thank you.
There he is, Milan Lucic, and here he is, Corey Sarge joining us here. And you promised me you'd smile the whole intermission because Berkey didn't smile, so great to have you back.
We got to make up for the lack of them in that first intermission.
Hey, what'd you make
of
Milan
Lucic?
Yeah, definitely, in the no-tie thing, yeah. But what did you make of Milan Lucic there? Just the idea of percentages. Put it 5-0. If it doesn't work, all of a sudden there's an opportunity.
Yeah, he makes great sense. You know, you're coming in off the wing like that, and why not take a shot? If it hits pad, he's got guys driving the net for a rebound. So it's a heck of a lot better than missing the net. You don't ever want to do that when you're that close.
Let's talk about this game, because this game, I think the theme so far through 40 minutes is chances. Calgary's generating them, but you maybe have a theory on why.
I just think the D-zone coverage by the Pittsburgh Penguins has been very weak tonight. There's been a lot of flaws. I know this is a very good puck-moving defense, but I think, you know, as far as shoring it up in their own end, they've really struggled tonight. There's been a few individual efforts, too, that maybe have been a little bit lackluster and subpar. You don't ever want to fault Chris Letang. He's a great defenseman out there on the ice. He's had a few bounce by him, but it was a really weak start, and the Flames took advantage of it. They just haven't quite capitalized on the score sheet. Right here, Michael Backlund misses a wide-open net. I guess I got to give the defenseman a little credit there for tying up the stick, but there's been a lot of plays like this one here on Johnny Gaudreau. You can't fade into the background and let a prime scorer like that have the ability to take a shot in a wide open look.
But you know, inside that room, Sarge, they're talking about, we've got to capitalize. We have to finish this minute.
Yeah, that's what the Flames are talking about right now. And you know what the Pens are going to be talking about is shoring it up. They spent so much time in their end that period. They've got to be exhausted. And defensemen have got to be talking to the forwards, trying to figure out a plan. They've got to get down to the Calgary Flames end if they're going to gain any traction. But expect the Flames to come and press and try to keep that momentum down in the Pens end.
You know, it's not a news story, but when Sidney Crosby comes to Western Canada, it's still a big deal. You had a chance to play against him, rather. More on that in a minute. But there was a neat quote this morning from Dylan Dubé, who was talking about coming here as a boy to the Saddle Dome to watch Sidney Crosby.
I think I was probably 9 or 10 years old. I came to the Dome to watch him in pregame skate. So it was it's pretty cool, but, you know, it's even cooler playing with Milan Lucic. He was by far my favorite player when I was 10 years old.
How about that? And Lucic goes out, thanks to that vote of confidence, and scores his sixth of the season.
Does he have to say it because he sits pretty close to him in the dressing room? He knows he's going to get a backhand.
And he was sitting right beside him at the podium today, so that's great. But just the aura around him. I mean, Matthew Tkachuk was also talking about it. He still looks forward to playing against him. Still, with the resume that Crosby has, second to none, and certainly just the idea of getting a healthy Sidney Crosby is essential. And it was Milan Lucic who said this morning, Corey, that, you know, you forget about how close the thought was that maybe his career was coming to an end. You played against him. Just an overall thought on what it's like to try and contain him and what it was like to have him bearing down.
He reminds me a lot of his predecessor. I got to play a little bit against Mario Lemieux, and you don't realize Sidney Crosby's strength on his skates. I always wondered, why didn't people run over Mario Lemieux and just take him out of the game? Why don't people just run Sidney Crosby out of the game? These guys are strong, they're durable, they work on their core, they're big men, and they're great playmakers. I mean, they don't put themselves in positions to get hit. They're very difficult to play against. The thing about Sidney Crosby is he was so dangerous on his forehand, so dangerous on his backhand. And when we talk about him all the time, I get nervous because there's highlight packs out there that contain me. And I'm glad we don't have any
getting
of those
posterized, if
right
you will.
Now.
Yes, you're an example for some.
One more thing too, Ryan, his resiliency to the injuries that he sustained too, and to come back and come back and come back. We need him in the game. He's a great player.
It was Lucic this morning who said not only a great competitor but a motivator too. He hadn't played with him, but he always knew about his motivation and what kind of a leader he was. I think everybody knows that, but the motivation really stood out for me.
And you hear about Brian Burke, who's been around the game for forever, and, you know, he's got experience with all types of different players. To talk about Sidney Crosby's work ethic being first and foremost, I mean, I would just gather it from the outside. I don't have never really talked personally with anybody that is close to Sidney, but you're not that good without putting in all the work.
Right. Matthew Tkachuk, he was asked about it on After Hours, about the rumors surrounding the trade and what, you know, was his name involved. And I think most people who follow this team know that Matthew Tkachuk was never going to be involved in any kind of Jack Eichel trade, but he did address it on Saturday.
I mean, if you're have any intelligence with the sport, and a lot of people do, they kind of saw right through that just like me, so it didn't really bother me that much, but I don't think they realized that. It's the people around me that were probably more rattled about it than I was, so I'm very happy it didn't happen. I'm very happy here. This place has been very, very special to me throughout my, I don't even know what it is, 6 years now, and I've loved it ever since I came here as 18.
It's not an easy thing to deal with rumors. You know, everybody goes through it in their career, but Matthew Tkachuk seems to have kind of everything in the rear view right now. I mean, he's smiling. You see him around the rink. You see what his line's been able to do. It's been very impressive. So good on him. It's what you have to do as a professional. It's a sport, and I think he's handled himself very well in light of the situation.
Happiest, he said, that he's ever been in his career playing here, and why not? Things are rolling for he and his teammates right now. They're enjoying a 1-0 lead thanks to the big man, Luch. With a sixth. It's 1-0 Calgary. Fred VanVleet and the Raptors. Tune in tomorrow, 7 Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific on Sportsnet and Sportsnet Now as we hand things off to Rick and Kelly.
Thank you, Ryan. Third period is upon us in a 1-0 Calgary lead through 40 minutes of play. Backlund out against Crosby, wins the faceoff. This one back underway as Anderson puts the puck up the wing, and it's tipped in by Mangiapane. Jarry out to slow it down. He'll fire it back towards the corner, up the boards. Knocked down by Gensel. He's knocked down by Mangiapane. And he gets the puck free to Coleman. Back to Mangiapane. Trying to walk through, but it's broken up and cleared by Letang. Too hard. And that'll be icing on Pittsburgh.
And here, take a look at Jarry. First time he's going to handle the puck. Bobbles it a little bit, but knows he's going to have some forecheck pressure, so he rips it high and hard around the board, so it gets past the two Calgary Flame forecheckers. Now, Gensel doesn't do the best job clearing the zone, but that isn't on Jarry. He did exactly what he was asked to do. High and hard off the glass.
Lindholm wins the draw against Crosby. Here's Hanifin with a shot, and that went just wide. Anderson gets the puck back to Tkachuk, to Lindholm behind the net for Gaudreau. He's checked by Pettersson, who takes it away and plays it ahead to Rodriguez. Got it out, but the Flames are on it. And here's Lindholm back on the attack, knocked off his stick. Puck comes free to Gensel. Backhands it in. Evan Rodriguez up on the forecheck. Jeff Carter there too. Flames get the puck free. Gaudreau plays it across. Tanev with a chance to bring it out. Gains center ice, plays it deep. Jarry will stop that, or try to anyway, behind the net, but it got away. Puck to the line and out before Shillington could get to it, so he'll pump it back to Tanev. Back across to Oliver Shillington. Turns some pressure. Flames finish off a change. Tanev gives it back to Shillington up the middle. Monahan denied entry by Ruedel. Zilker plays the puck across to an open wing. Shillington takes a look and sees Tanev on the other side. Banks the puck to him. He puts it up the boards. Jeff Carter bats at it. Flames back on it. Shillington fans on the pass, but Monahan takes control and carries in. Fake shoot stopped by Jarry. Top of the crease. He hangs on.
This period brought to you by Toyota RAV4. There's more out there to experience.
Let's take a look at this chance by Sean Monahan. Shillington fans on his pass, but it actually goes right to Monahan, so he gets an opportunity from the top of the faceoff circle. And pretty easy save from Jarry.
And the shot buys it all off. That went off Monahan after the faceoff. It up the boards and then flip it back down the near side where Pintlick waits for it to settle down. He's knocked down. Matheson steals the puck, gives it to Dominic Simone, who's had a couple of chances in this game.
The two best chances by the Penguins in the second period.
And they'll chase the puck. Zadorov sweeps it away to an open wing out at center ice. And the line, it squirts across. Clear it out. Simone makes a play. Carried in now by Hyde, and he fell. That had a look, but he stumbled, and Flames able to clear. Bluger back to it. John Marino across to Mike Matheson. Off a
Calgary sticking out. It bounces to Zach Aston-Reese. Here's Lafferty in on Tanev. Puck comes free to Lewis. Letang pitching though. Markstrom sweeps it around. Lucic back to him. Tip it back to Tanev. Penguins hard on the forecheck. Lafferty throws another hit, but Tanev stands his ground and makes a pass to Lucic. Got the puck on the line, not out. Following up is Richardson. He clears. Lucic backhands it in. Patterson flushed out. Will make a play over Letang, and he has room to bring the puck to center. Flipped into the zone. It rolls right to Markstrom, who tips it quickly over to Hannafin. Bad pass. Played to the high slot. Now it's Gensel turning. They're working up the boards. Back to Letang. Long shot, and Markstrom grabs that and hangs on.
What looked to be a really good attempt by Pittsburgh fails. Simone gets a puck quickly to Heinen. Watch this. He's going to set up to rip it on net. Unfortunately for him, he loses an edge and takes away an opportunity. The best one, and here he is on the bench. And can you believe it? Seriously. I haven't had a look all game. I get my first one and then I fall.
That's six this season. Tough to score from your side though.
Yeah. He's been a good addition. Brian Burke has talked about that.
Signed a free agent deal in the summer from Anaheim. Shot off the draw by Matheson that went off a leg. Gensel pressured by Hannafin. Crosby crashes into the crowd. Puck comes free. Mangiapane, stick tied up. Able to get it free and work the puck out with a bank pass for Coleman. He'll chase. Jarry tipped it away from Coleman. Matheson's pass picked off. Richardson put it in front. Chip just went by Coleman. Stolen by Mangiapane. Back across, and Crosby got there ahead of Richardson. Kept in by Gudbranson. Just stolen back by Crosby. Clears, but Coleman's right back on the attack. Was an all-off shot. Stopped by Jarry. Out the challenge. Makes the save and hangs on.
Mike Matheson, dependable defenseman, but he makes a terrible mistake behind the net. Throws a puck away right there, and it goes right to Richardson. He quickly throws it to the front, and there's Coleman. He can't redirect that in. Coleman gets a second opportunity, though, from fairly well out, and Jarry makes a save with no rebound.
Lindholm wins the faceoff. Shillington takes a look over to Tanev. Slap pass, steered wide by Tkachuk. That had potential. Tkachuk gets it behind the net. Dubalin cuts it off. And Zucker with a chance to flip it ahead to Carter. Not away from him out of neutral ice. And here's Shillington back on the attack. Over to Gaudreau. Looks it across to Tkachuk. Knocked down in the corner. Stays in the battle. Zucker winds up with a puck. Tipped out and poked away by Pittsburgh forward Brock McGinn all the way back to the Calgary zone, and Shillington makes a pass to Gaudreau. Lost the handle for a moment, dumps it back to Shillington. 4.5 minutes gone here in the third. What about Pittsburgh and the sale of the Penguins that just happened today, Kelly? And Fenway Group, the owners of the Boston Red Sox and Liverpool.
And it's good to see Mario and Ron Burkle still being a part of it, right?
There's a nice chance there for Dubé, but I was just thinking about it, speaking of Mario and Burkle. You know, they rescued the team out of bankruptcy in 99.
Right.
The Penguins are in danger of moving. They were in a lot of financial trouble. Mario and company stepped in. They saved the team from bankruptcy. And the rumor is they sold just now for $900 million.
Wow.
So it was $900 million here, $900 million. Pretty soon you're talking about some serious money.
Well, if I'm not mistaken, Forbes ranked them, I think, around $675 million about a year ago. So,
wow.
That is wow, is right.
It's a great story, Matt. You know, the history now with this franchise, with five Stanley Cup banners and all that, it might well have died in Pittsburgh had it not been for Mario this park.
You're so right. Certainly didn't help that they had Crosby come in and save the franchise as well. They're still playing in the old igloo, which saw better times, I can tell you that.
Good hustle by Bluger to take off an icing call. The puck comes all the way around for Kapanen. He's pumped by Zadorov. Monahan steps into his man. That was Simone and knocked him down. Pitlick gets the puck back and drops it off to Gudbranson. Banking ahead and out, just out of the reach of Pitlick. Late in the shift anyway. Turns to the bench. Quick up, finds Kapanen. Simone goes to the net. There's the pass, and it's right on goal. Markson turns it away. Backlund heads down the wing. Trying to cut through the middle. Backhands it in. Latang back under pressure. The turn from Mangiapane. And puts it up the board to Jake Gensel. His pass out the center finds Kapanen. Gain the red line and fire that one. One in wide. Gensel racing onto it. Crosby off the bench into the play. Anderson leans on Gensel. Puck tip free to Crosby. Trying to settle it down. Backlund in his hip pocket. Crosby gets it back. Makes a play to Letang. Turn off the boards. Backhand pass across. Pedersen shoots. Glove saved by Markstrom. And then a little pushing and shoving between Crosby and a couple of Flames, but that settles down quickly. And now Anderson to Crosby. Anderson to Crosby got it.
Okay, there's Crosby and Backlund behind the net. Backlund was shadowing Crosby. Crosby had the chance in front. He didn't like it, took exception. Now Anderson's coming to his rescue.
Well, we haven't had a power play yet in this game, and I don't think we'll get one here, but temper's flaring a little after Crosby and Backlund went at it first. Still 1-0 Calgary on Sportsnet.
Jari, terrific, 24 saves. Let's go back to opening faceoff, though. He's got his little routine or superstitious act going on, and notice it's the left crossbar post. Did he cast a spell, Rick? That's what I want to know. There's Goudreau and Trevor Lewis. Two times to hit the post, and maybe his little routine helped him.
I like you cut the fact that you called the routine, because the great Wally Buono once told me when I said, I didn't know you're superstitious. It's not superstitious routine. His chance! Great save by Jari off the chuck. That's the save of the game right there. He did a handful on that one. Was a beauty to keep it a one-goal game.
I like that spell, Wally Buono, because that is true, right?
Yep. Tag back in his own line. That was a stop and a half right there. Jari keeping this close with his 26th save of the hockey game. Didn't need to post that time.
No, you're right.
Help. Lewis checked. Carter comes free. Shillington skated to the line. Lucic, who has the goal in this game, down the wing with a pass across, deflected high. Carter back on it. Away from him, but now the Penguins break up. Two of them in. Zucker makes a move. Got a weak shot away, and Panic got a stick on that. Stephen High. Rui will pick a bump from Brad Richardson. Bump goes deep. Panic's there. Now the board's off. Dumoulin sticking out. The race board. Lewis trying to get there. Dumoulin feed it to it. Lucci follows up. Passes to Monahan. In by himself. Waiting for support. Finds it now. And Zadorov. Finch shoots, and that's off Rui's stick. And out of play.
Well, we talked about the forecheck and being heavy on the Pittsburgh defense. Let's take a look at Matthew Tkachuk. He's just going to fire it around into the far corner. He knows Lindholm is right there. Lindholm puts it on net. Matthew Tkachuk goes right to the front of the net. Smart play by Tkachuk. He even elevates it. You can tell by his expression that he thought that was a sure goal.
Bluger waved out. Simone in to face off against Monahan. And wins it for Pittsburgh.
There's a real intensity to this game, isn't there, right now, Rick?
Yep.
You can just feel it.
And that's just enough for icing. Ryan.
Rick, CP Rail Goals for Kids is proudly sponsored by Canadian Pacific and its 2,000 railroaders in Calgary. For every Flames home goal scored this season, CP will donate $500 to Kids Sport and the Flames Even Strength Program. Keep scoring, Calgary Flames.
Monahan against Bluger in the faceoff circle. Monahan clean win, back to Zadorov, over to Gudbranson. Wrist shot blocked. Simone got in the way and gets the puck out. Eric Gudbranson. Cross to Zadorov. 8 minutes gone, third period. Zadorov ahead to Dubé. And they're going to blow that down on an icing call.
Is So we've talked about Simone. He's played really well for Pittsburgh. Never was quite a good fit here in Calgary, but does a nice job getting in the shooting lane at Gudbranson. And then because of that, they're able to exit the zone. But I think he's played really well here, Rick.
I agree. You know, it's interesting how some guys fit on certain. Yeah. He was a good utility forward for Pittsburgh, right? Move him up right. And down the line. When he's there, came to Calgary, just never worked.
It just didn't.
And he was back in Pittsburgh, and yeah, he's been playing better. Flames able to change after the icing call. Letang on it. Here's Rodriguez, gains the zone, puts the puck in deep to Crosby. Shift behind the net to Gensel. We'll chase a rolling puck to the corner, but a good play there by Hannah to break up. Coleman pokes it past the defenseman and gets pushed to the boards. Has one an interference call that doesn't come. They have a case. Still haven't had a power play in this game. Here's Crosby. Put it in front. Joining the rush was Letang, but he couldn't get the shot away. Now a feed finds Mangiapane working in on Ruedel. Mangiapane knocked down. Good play by Chad Ruedel to knock Mangiapane down. The puck's cleared up. Mangiapane rolled back on it. And on the attack as he dances in. Here's Gaudreau. That shot denied by Zucker. Steered away. Gave it away to Gaudreau. Trying to get it in front. Lindholm was all by himself with the pass in the back of the net. And the Penguins cleared his own too far. And that'll be icing.
Well, you heard the fans, Rick. They're calling for an interference penalty on Letang. Coleman definitely had a step on him. There's no question that Letang steps into him. I'm going to take one more look at it, and that is just a missed call. We were raving about the officials earlier in the game making a great play, and then Zucker with two good plays. Although he gives a puck over, turns a puck over after the first good defensive play, then he makes another second one to recover.
Puck bouncing into the zone. Markstrom there to feed it out to Kachuk. Roller got away. Reno just off the bench, able to make a pass to Carter, but left to reset back in his own zone with a pass back to Pettersson. As we approach the midway mark of the third period, good play by Kachuk to break up that pass and flip it in. Here's Gaudreau trying to get around Marino, knock the puck away. Chipped it up the boards for Zucker. He's knocked down. Carter follows up and he'll feed the puck in. Nikita Zadorov goes back to it. 10 minutes gone, third period. Zadorov to Branson. And now Lewis flips it out. John Marino makes a play near side for Lafferty. Zach Nastenreese into the zone. Checked. Flipped out by Zadorov. A little too hard, and that's an icing call. Once again, here's Ryan.
Well, for an in-depth look at the biggest stories from around the National Hockey League, check out 32 Thoughts, the podcast with Jeff Merrick and Elliot Friedman, presented by GMC. New episodes drop Mondays and Fridays on sportsnet.ca or wherever you stream your podcasts.
Well, this is similar to Saturday, isn't it, Rick? You and Cassie called that one, and that was a tight game, 2-2 in the third, and Kyle Connor scored that big goal, but this
beautiful
this,
shot.
Beautiful shot. This has that same sort of feel. There's plenty of drama left.
Yep. Not over yet. Blake nursing a 1-0 lead midway through the third period. Puck in deep. Lafferty pushed to the board by Zadorov. By the way, Winnipeg put a pile of shots on net against Arizona tonight and lost 1-0.
Yeah, right. So
offense continues to struggle even though they got that win here on Saturday.
They outshot Arizona 46-15.
Here's Lewis down the wing. Pushed to the board by Marino as the puck goes to the corner. Matheson turning. Makes the play out to Heinen. Canepin on him. Noah Hanifin fires it across to Anderson. Off it. Retreat. Settle it down. Now Dubé takes the pass. Plays it in for Pitlick. Kluger there first. Put it across in front of his own net. Dangerous, but got away with it. Up to the line. Not out. Nice play there by Hanifin to keep it alive. And Pitlick racing onto it. Chips a pass to Dubé on the other side. He's tied up along the boards by Simone. And jab away at the puck. Bounces free to the circle. Play to the corner of Dubé. Makes a pass to Monahan. Over to Hanifin with a bit of room. Hanifin shoots, stopped by Jari. Found that through traffic, turned it away. Dubé protects the puck with a pass to Pitlick. And that goes off a stick and into the netting. 8:13 to go in the third period. We've got a tie one here in Calgary. 1-0 Flames on Sportsnet. Flames.
Pretty easy to pick this one, Rick. It's 1-0, so we're going to go with the goal by Milan Lucic. Gets around Lou Weedle, and then goes to his favorite spot. Scored 3 of his 6 goals on the season. 5 goals. Absolutely terrific release. And Milan is having another excellent game. As everybody knows, if you've been here to the Scotiabank Saddle Dome, he is a fan favorite.
They love him, and they love that. And that's the only goal so far, as you mentioned, Kelly, with 8:13 to go in the third period. Backlund out to face off again against Sidney Crosby. Who wins it for Pittsburgh. Letang makes a quick pass to Gensel. He'll feed it out. Anderson back under pressure from Rodriguez, but he stepped over the line early, and that's an offside call.
Rodriguez has been called the Swiss Army knife by their coach Mike Sullivan for many reasons. He came over from Buffalo, and he just does everything really, really well. Can play anywhere in your lineup. He can be a centerman. Right now he's on line with Crosby and Gensel, right winger. But he's just shown great speed, good hands, and he supports those two players, Crosby and Gensel, really, really well in the offensive zone.
Off the draw, play down the ice. That'll be icing again. First call was offside. That one's icing, and the faceoff goes back to the other end. Hey, it's good to have Buds back in the stands. They always make the game better, Kelly. You know that. That's what Buds do.
Whoa, slow down there. That was quite the drink.
Got to pace yourself, buddy.
Right. There's more where that comes from, right? Not the last one on the planet.
8 minutes to go in the third period. And Crosby and Backlund, although Backlund's tossed, Mangiapane steps in, proceeds to win it, kicks it back to Coleman, but he puts it between Hannifin and Anderson with the reset out of center. Put in by Anderson. Played to the line and out.
And I hope that young lady takes no offense. I'm just having a little bit of fun.
Here's Rodriguez on the attack. Gensel from behind the net. Looks for Letang. Feeds it across. Dumoulin shoots, and that goes off Hannifin's leg. Over to Coleman. And we have a penalty coming up. And the first power play of the game comes with 7.5 minutes to go. And it'll be a Pittsburgh power play, as headed off is Michael Backlund.
So let's take a look at Backlund. He's right in front, and he's trying to box out the flow. Yeah, and then he not only does he box him out, Rodriguez, but he throws him down to the ice. So he's going to take a 2-minute penalty for interference. Could have been holding as well.
Pittsburgh power play is only 28th in the league. Now, they didn't have Crosby for a long period of time, and they still don't have Malkin. That'll hurt.
Right. Carter was out. They've had Letang was out. They've had a lot of people out of the lineup.
Flames have the second best penalty kill in the NHL. Only Pittsburgh's is better.
Yep. Played by number 11. Crosby.
Off a stick in the slot. It's a power play goal. Took just 7 seconds after the penalty was called, and it's all tied up at 1.
So Pittsburgh wins a faceoff, and they quickly set it up. They get Crosby on the flank, and he's going to spot Gensel right in the high slot. There it is. Watch his stick of Gensel. He gets it away from the coverage of Tanev. That's such a great play by Gensel. Twice Tanev tried to make contact with the stick, and that's just a terrific pass and a better deflection by Gensel.
Who gets his 9th, and then... And then it went off the toe of Tanev. Watch this right there.
Boom. Oh, yeah, you're right.
Yep, yep. So a tip and a deflection off the foot of the Flames defenseman, and it's a power play goal that ties this up at 1. He talked about it, Kelly. It's a tight game. I mean, it's... And now it's tied, but Flames were protecting that 1-goal lead. Some chances to add to it. Johnny made a couple of great saves. Not better than that stop off Matthew Tkachuk. Seven minutes to go. Crosby and Letang get the assist on that power play goal. Now the Flames look to answer back. Here's Johnny Gaudreau dumping the puck in and around.
Chuck trying to work it off the boards, knocked away by Carter and picked up by Brock McGinn, who feeds it out towards Zucker. Off him back in. Flames say it shouldn't be offside, but might have gone off a flame. Either way, they blow it down.
Well, you can tell these two players, Crosby and Guentzel, have such chemistry, right? Like, take a look at Crosby. You could see Guentzel, and it's an elevated pass, and Crosby trusts the hand-eye coordination of Guentzel so much that he just throws it into an area, knowing with that skill set, there's a good likelihood he's going to get a stick on it.
Erik Branson fires the puck in. Jari stops that behind the net for John Marino. Simon topped it up. Here's Dubé. Tip back to Gabranson. Shot blocked. Puck comes outside the line. Zadorov hustles over to it. Pass for Monahan. Slowed down by Bluger. Now flipped in by Pitlick. Matheson there. Flames force a turnover. Good job by Zadorov to keep it onside. In deep for Monahan. Get it back to Anderson. Long shot. Ooh, that hurt. That cut Simone up high. Second shot deflects. Simone's down now that Penguins have the puck, so they blow the play down. Dominic Simone back on his feet. Good to see, but always scary when that puck gets up like that, and he'll go right to the room.
Yes, he will. That was a rolling puck that Rasmus Anderson tried to put on the net. You can see it's rolling, and it goes directly up. Oh, boy, that gets him. It's hard to say, but that might be right in the face.
Side of the helmet, maybe?
Let's hope so. Yeah. There's that rolling puck again. It's very difficult to tell exactly where it hits, but let's hope he's okay.
Backlund out against Crosby in the faceoff circle again.
So that's 5 points now for Crosby. Three games.
Yep.
Last three.
Latang. Cut off by Pullman. Here's Backlund. Mangiapane. Anderson. Takes a look. Doesn't have a shot. Puts it in behind for Mangiapane. Now Pullman. Here's Hannafin. Long shot. The flight never got through. Backlund's back on it. In front. Pat saved by Jari. That time off Pullman. Got the right leg out to make the save. Pullman's had a few looks in this game.
Yes.
Number of them. 5.5 to go, third period. Over to Rasmus Anderson. Mal Hannafin. Kachuk. Gaudreau. Jari out to play it around to the other side. Kept in by Kachuk. Lindholm. Around the boards for Shillington. That's Indy. Gets it to Gaudreau. Makes a play that's tipped. Tanev gets the puck, though, over to Shillington. Fires it across for Gaudreau. Able to bat it back to the boards and get it himself. Kachuk, Gaudreau, across now to Shillington. He shoots and put that high. Trying to go top corner, didn't miss by much. Tanev activates. Kachuk's knocked down behind the net by Patterson. There's one to call it, doesn't come, and now Carter chases. Tanev's back, just enough for icing as they blow it down with 4:27 left in the third.
And you mentioned it, Rick. Pullman has had a number of good chances. He gets a nice pass from Michael Backlund. And then he's going to find himself open on the far side. Watch this quick reaction from Jari. And let's take a look at the no call. I guess that's questionable on Pettersson, whether that should have been a penalty against Kachuk. You can discuss at home whether you think so or not.
Less of an issue with that one than the non-interference right. call at center ice. That would seem more clear. That wasn't called. Ruedel over to Zucker. Zadorov goes back. Penguins change now after that icing call. Zadorov gives the puck to Lewis. Gains center and dumps it in. Jari again stops the puck up the boards. Lewis cuts it off. Lucic lost a stick. Lucic broke. Had to drop it. As Gabranson's back on the puck. And Lucic. He heads off. Here's Marino. Long pass. Winds up right on goal. Markstrom leaves that for Anderson. Voroff gets the pass. Kluber gets the puck. Voroff on him. Monahan comes in to help. Rasmus Anderson's pass gets to the corner. Gets it back himself. And now Monahan trying to flip it ahead and does. Dubé out with Pitlick. Two on two. Dubé swings wide. Puck goes in behind the net. Where Monahan gets control in front. And that's turned away. His Hennepin got the shot away. Jari got a piece of that one. Pitlick back on it. Hennepin waiting for it near the blue line. Puts the puck in behind again. Anderson's there. Here's Monahan. Pass blocked. Hennepin pinching down the boards. Steers it back to the line of Pitlick. Wrists it in deep for Dubé. Dylan Dubé. Back to the line of Anderson. Here's Dubé again from the circle. Cuts across, tried a shot, and that's intercepted. And Kaplan with a chance to work it up. And he elects to turn back as the Penguins start to change, and so do the Flames. Inside 3 minutes to go in the third period of a tie hockey game here in Calgary. Gensel plays it ahead to Crosby. Puts the puck in. Markstrom puts it around the glass. Puck to the line. Letang puts it in deep. Picked off by Shillington, trying to spring Mangiapane. Has a step, has Coleman in front. Mangiapane turning, can't get a shot away. Drops it off, Backlund takes a look. Pass blocked by Letang. Backlund stays on it, and Crosby calmly plays the puck to the other side. Mangiapane pressuring, Coleman steals. Tied up along the boards, put to the line and up. Tanev settles it down. Plays it across to Shillington. Final 2 minutes of regulation time. Scotiabank Saddledome. Final meeting this season between these two. Flames won in Pittsburgh on a 45-save shutout by Markstrom. Jari's been great between the pipes tonight. As Carter puts the puck towards the goal, comes all the way around. Golfed at by Gaudreau. Scooped up by Hennepin. Fires a pass to Kachuk. Couldn't take it. Lindholm settles it down, and now Hennepin has it again. Rubio stands his ground. The girl gets it loose. Brad Richardson carries in with a shot off the leg of Zucker. Puck goes in behind the net. Now it's back to Tanev. He takes a look, shoots, and that's off traffic in front. And the puck winds up going out of play.
Shillington showing all sorts of confidence with a stretch pass right up the middle to Mangiapane. And then just look at the defensive effort by the Penguins to recover. How's Letang? It does a nice job. Because Mangiapane was in behind them. Great skating ability by Letang. You know, by the way, Chris Letang is one of my favorite players in the game. I don't think he's played all that great tonight. He is, in my estimation, he's made 5 or 6 average plays with the puck. And I expect that next game, Wednesday in Edmonton, he's going to be much, much better.
Off the draw, Lucic puts the puck to the corner for Lewis. Whips it up the boards now for Shillington. Locks it across, balls. Popped up, Astros with a pass to Parker Carter. Not far enough for Eisen. They'll find him in the play in the third. As the puck's played ahead by Tanev, and now batted out by Richardson. Lucic follows up. Taken away by Letang. He's checked, but the puck goes right to Bluger as the Flames peel off for a change. Aston Reese down the wing. Pushed to the boards by Mangiapane. And now Backlund with a chance to bring it out. Has Coleman with him as they skate the center. Anderson joins the rush. Here's Coleman over the line. Coleman winds up, shoots, glove save. Jari saw that one all the way, and he hangs on.
And here's another opportunity by Blake Coleman. We've mentioned many times he's been all around it today, and this one he's just looking for a rebound. He sees lots of players going to the net, and Jari once again, his rebound control has just been terrific tonight. Very rarely has he given up a juicy rebound.
That's Coleman's 5th shot on goal in this game. Backlund and Crosby in the faceoff circle. Puck to the boards. Coleman gets it. Around the wall to Anderson on the other side. A roller. Blasts it back down low. Hopped over Coleman's stick. Backlund got the stick up in the face of Rodriguez. No call. Here's Coleman in front. Puck comes all the way back. Anderson. That that shot blocked. Knocked away by Backlund. Good play on Gensel to steal the puck, so he could send Crosby in for a late chance. And this one is headed to overtime. As 60 minutes in the books, we're all tied up at one. So Milan Lucic scored in the second to make it 1-0 Calgary. And then Jake Gensel, 12 and a half minutes in the third, ties it up. Overtime next on Sportsnet.
How? And no surprise here, it's Tristan Jarry. He has just been spectacular. Not a lot of work, 30 shots, but he has made many outstanding saves. This, in my opinion, has been a terrific effort by the Calgary Flames, and if not for Jarry, the Flames would have had a regulation win. And he continues his strong play. He was named NHL second star of the week. He's only given up 3 goals in his last 6 games. And just look how confident he looks and nice and relaxed going into this overtime, the start of the 5-game road trip.
Shots 30-21 in Calgary's favor through 60 minutes. Let's take a look, Kelly, at how we got here. 2 goals in this game, and here they are.
All right, Lucic with a great individual effort, gets past the defenseman, goes 5-goal. And then on the power play, Pittsburgh, Sidney Crosby, wants Jake Gensel in the high slot. There's the redirect. It actually does go off the toe of Chris Tanev, as you pointed out, Rick. And that's why we are headed to overtime.
Flames are 1-5 in overtime this season. They're due. Pittsburgh 1-1 in games that end in overtime.
And they've lost 3 here in the Scotiabank Saddledome, the Flames. So,
Mangiapane, Lindholm, Shillington will start the overtime. For Calgary, Gensel, Crosby, and Marino for Pittsburgh. Crosby directing traffic. Lindholm not happy with the alignment.
Right.
All right, yeah. Reset.
Oh, he wanted out.
He did, and it went off his own foot right to John Marino. Jake Gensel leaves the puck for Crosby. As he winds up out of his own zone and backhands the pass to Gensel. Leaves it for Marino. And crisscross out at center. And there's Crosby again. Gathering speed through neutral ice. Carries in. Crosby throws the pass across. And Gensel fan on the one-time attempt. Flames get the puck. Crosby hassling, Markstrom covers up. Now he floods it over to Lindholm. It was a good play by Markstrom. And a long pass by Mangiapane. Working down the wing. Shillington going to the net. There's the pass. Shot away. Pass was deflected and he couldn't get a clean shot away. As Jeff Carter's on, Flames change up. And off the bench and just in time to take the puck is Chris Tanev. And bump it back across to Johnny Gaudreau. Flips a pass out, finds its mark. Backlund in with Tanev. Gaudreau joins late, takes the pass, off the crossbar. Jarry may have got a piece of that, and the puck goes out of play as Johnny Gaudreau had a great look there. And can't believe it.
Let's take a look at the first good opportunity by Crosby. First to speed here, he finds the cross-seam pass to Gensel right in the wheelhouse. He just can't contain it. And here's Mangiapane to Shillington, who's joining the rush. Just great play by Jeff Carter to take away that, and then Johnny Gaudreau gets an opportunity. One more post on the same side on Tristan Jarry.
Well, Jarry's, whatever he did with the post to start the game, it's working. Here comes Backlund trying to end this one. Can't get a shot away as he was angled off by Matheson, so we'll circle back, give the puck to Gaudreau. Gaudreau swings in deep. Around the net, back to Tanev. Regroup back out at center ice. Minute 40 gone in overtime. Tanev turns back as Gaudreau heads off. Coleman on. And so is Dubé, who takes control on wheels out. Dubé in, shoots, and that goes off a stick high and wide. Around the boards to Coleman. We'll bump it back to Noah Hanifin. Crosby wants a change. Hanifin brings the puck out. He'll work it over the line himself. Hanifin shoots, and that goes wide around the boards. Dubé will have to race back to it. That's time to get to the puck. And now a quick up might take advantage of a sloppy change by the Penguins. Pass just off the mark, though. Coleman hustles to it. Comes free, and it's settled down by John Marino. So Marino will take his time and make a play to Carter. Over to Kapanen, lost control, but trying to get it back. Poked away by Shillington. Carter's back on it for Pittsburgh. Passes over to Marino. Carter. Kapanen. Lost an edge. Has to pump it back to his goaltender.
Good, smart play by Kapanen.
Here's a long pass by Jarry. Off his skate, and they go offside as Jarry tried to spring Zucker. Hey, it would have been fitting with the night he's had to get an assist on a potential game winner, but it goes offside at the Calgary blue line.
Noah Hanifin, there's lots of traffic, but he didn't recognize he had Blake Coleman right to the left. He would have had an easy entrance into the zone. He didn't notice it. Now he does spot Coleman, but Coleman takes his eye off it, and all of a sudden that is dead. And then this was a really good play by Kapanen. He recognized he lost an edge, and he was going down, so he better put the puck back to his goaltender.
Inside 2 minutes to go in overtime. Anderson has it. And Gaudreau takes the pass. Wheeling in on Letang. Dropped it off for Backlund. Watched by Rodriguez. Backlund gives the puck to Gaudreau. Had it taken away. Good play by Letang as he takes off. Anderson comes over to angle him off, and a nice stop by Gaudreau. It's a 2-on-1, now a 3-on-1 the other way. Backlund with Gaudreau and Anderson. Anderson shoots, stopped by Jarry. Took that one up high. Now it's the 2-on-1 the other way. And Zucker works it in. Here's Letang. Saved by Markstrom. Puck sits loose. Gaudreau heads up ice. Might be a 2-on-1 Calgary. Backlund racing in. Gaudreau gets a shot away. Chance for Gaudreau, who can't believe it. What a performance tonight by Tristan Jarry, and Johnny Gaudreau denied after chances at both ends.
And what plays Letang with a bad choice here. It leads to this 3-on-1, and Anderson goes up high. Jarry gets a piece of that. And then Letang gets another chance offensively, and he's saved by Markstrom. Good play, but all of a sudden it goes back the other way, and Johnny on a bit of a broken play. Gets this one, he does elevate. He gets the puck past Sidney Crosby. Incredible action.
Faceoff win Calgary. Here's Montgomery. Final minute play of overtime as he walks it across. Puts the puck over to Lindholm. He'll reset out at center ice. How many $10 has Jarry made tonight? He's been something else.
He sure has.
Andrew Mangiapane shakes Crosby. Carries in. Stops on the half boards. Knocked away. Tanev races to it. He gets there ahead of Matheson. Tanev trying to spring Mangiapane. A little too hot to handle. Might be icing. Hopped over a stick. And the faceoff will come back to the Calgary zone with 27.4 seconds to go.
This has been so fun. Both goaltenders have been great. Markstrom not the same work. But Jarry, seriously, this is just a tremendous effort. And this is one I'm going to remember for a long time. This is one of the tremendous efforts. We've seen many of them this year and over the years, but this is right up there.
Crosby with the faceoff win. Marino pressure, spins from Leno. Makes a play to Crosby. Good play by Tanev to knock it away. And make a pass to Mangiapane. 15 seconds to go in overtime. Mangiapane winding up out of his own zone. He'll carry in, shadowed by Gensel, slows it down, tries to fling it toward the goal. That's denied. Now it's played out, but not enough time, and this one will go to the shootout. Not for lack of chances. 65 minutes in the books, and we're still tied at one.
And Chris Tanev with a tremendous effort against Sidney Crosby. Crosby, one last effort, going to take the puck hard to the net, and a good stick by Chris Tanev to break up that opportunity.
Tell us Flames Hockey on Sportsnet. brought to you by TELUS, the network that gives back to help connect Canadians in need. Let's make the future friendly.
Well, this has been an intense game, Rick.
Yep.
You could just feel it early. There was great speed and tempo. First 15 minutes of the game, I thought the Flames carried the play. Then the last 5 minutes of the first period, it's Pittsburgh evened it out. And ever since, it's just been an excellent game and lots of really good individual efforts, good team structure by both sides. But there has been, you could really feel it. We talked about it in the third. There has been an intensity in this game.
Well, both these teams saw winning streaks come to an end on Saturday.
Yep.
Calgary's four-game win streak and seven-game point streak with that loss to Winnipeg. Pittsburgh had a five-game streak going when they dropped a 6-3 decision to Montreal. That was a weird game because they were up or they were down. They pulled the goal. They were five goals scored with the Pittsburgh goalie out of the net. Penguins scored two. Montreal had three empty netters.
Now, you could argue both those teams in the losing those winning streaks, they should have won those games. I think Calgary is better than Winnipeg to a certain degree. Hellebuck was great, and Jake Allen was the star of the show.
I would agree with that.
He had 47 saves for the Montreal Canadiens.
All right, Sean Monahan, first shooter. Monahan against Jarry. Stopped by Jarry.
And what Sean Monahan likes to do is go in slowly, take his time, see what's there, and oftentimes he's so accurate. He elevates and scores, but Jarry's just Johnny on the spot. Right,
Jake Gensel has the Pittsburgh goal. First shooter for the Penguins as he works in on Markstrom. Gensel off the crossbar. No, it was in. Caught the back post. And Gensel opens the scoring in the shootout.
Yeah, they'll take a look at this. Take a look. No speed whatsoever. Just trying to take his time.
Oh, I don't know.
From that angle, it's hard. This will give us everything we need to know.
Nope.
Nope. No.
I should never question myself, Kelly. I think that's the lesson we've learned here. That's not a goal.
Well, let me add, on occasion.
It sure looked like it was crossbar to me.
It did, yeah.
Yeah.
And you can see how Gensel just waiting to see what opens up. And no, almost a perfect shot.
Yeah. That's right. Maybe some of that Jarry magic rubbed off on Markstrom's goal. Here comes Tkachuk on Jarry. Tkachuk stopped by Jarry. Kicks that out with the right pad.
Nice play, Matthew Tkachuk, doing the same thing, going in slowly, trying to see what opens up. Decides that it's far low side, and just a really efficient save by Jarry.
All right, Crosby on Markstrom. He'll swing up to his left. Crosby, stopped by Markstrom, got a piece of that and steered it high.
Very similar to Gensel chance. Comes in fairly slowly, puts on the brakes, and just trying to locate an open area. And he decides also high gloves side, and Markstrom gets a piece of that one.
Johnny Gaudreau up next. Round three. Gaudreau scores!
Okay, that's a terrific release. Lots of deception in this one. He does the same thing. He's looking for an open spot. Watch the release. He appears to go that he might go five hole, and then all of a sudden just opens up the blade, and he fools Jarry.
Chris Letang has to score. Markstrom save will win it. Letang scores. Goes backhand upstairs. And it's on to round four.
Okay, talk about deception again. So Letang, it appears to me, he's showing that he's going to go high glove side right there, decides at that last moment, yes, he bit. Now I'm going to go backhand and elevate.
Andrew Mangiapane up next. Mangiapane on Jarry. Stop on Jarry. Tried to outwit him, but Jarry came across to make the save.
And you're exactly right, Rick. That's the thing about Jarry on this one. He's going to propel himself hard from his left to his right, but not go to the post. He goes to the shooter, Mangiapane, and so he takes away that angle.
Jeff Carter, 36-year-old, with a chance to win it for Pittsburgh. Stopped by Markstrom. It's
So lots to think about in this shootout. So instead of going high glove side, Carter's going to go blocker side, and Markstrom is all over it. Lots of deception in these shooters tonight.
Elias Lindholm up next for Calgary. Round five, Lindholm on Jari. Lindholm, stopped by Jari. Bats that one down with a glove.
And I think in this one, Lindholm is just hoping that Jari's going to move a little bit further to his right and open up the glove side. And you can see Jari just holds his position nicely.
Evan Rodriguez, next shooter for Pittsburgh, as he picks up the puck and works in on Markstrom. Rodriguez fakes, and that goes wide. Got in too deep. Markstrom may have got a piece of it, but we go on to round six.
I think he did, Rick. Rodriguez lost possession of this puck, and it actually goes to his backhand. And no, you know what? It just hit the outside of the post. I don't think Markstrom got a piece of it, although he sure stayed with him well.
Daryl Sutter sends out Oliver Shillington next. Sixth round, Shillington stopped by Jari, trying to go 5-0, and Jari's able to shut it down.
Yeah, he tried to get the goaltender Jari to open up. Goes ultimately, you know, I thought he kind of went to his backhand, but he didn't. There wasn't a lot of deception in that one. That was a fairly simple save by Jari.
Kasperi Kapanen with a chance to win it for Pittsburgh. Kapanen! Stopped by Markstrom. Got a piece of that at Stewart.
Yeah, similar play, Rick. I'm not sure what the scouting report they have on Markstrom is, but they're certainly all trying to go high, and if not, they're certainly going glove side. That's a good save by Markstrom.
Seventh round. Michael Backlund up next. Backlund scores!
Great shot. And what Michael Backlund is trying to do, similar to last shooter for the Flames, is that he's going to get him to try and move. He does, and then he goes cross body, high gloves side. That's a really terrific play by Michael Backlund.
Glove top corner, same as Gaudreau. Markstrom save on Brock McGinn will win it for Calgary. Here comes McGinn. Stop by Markstrom.
Well, this has been a really entertaining game. Plenty of drama. Action in the shootout, and Markstrom with the final save off Brock McGinn. And let's take a look at McGinn, what he's going to try and do. He's going to try and quickly go. Let's take a look at this first. That's a good win. McGinn's going to go to the far side quickly. He tries to make one extra step. And Markstrom's all over. Watch this at the end. He tries to go hard to his left. McGinn does. 5 feet. He's going to try and accelerate hard in the last 5 feet and hope that Markstrom can't get over in time, but he does. Great save by Markstrom. Here's the celebration. Nice win for the Flames.
Took 65 minutes and 7 rounds of a shootout, but we have a decision. Flames win 2-1. Back to wrap things up with some final thoughts on Sportsnet next.